baseball's postseason, the 72nd All-Star Game, and beginning June 2nd, the Saturday Baseball Game of the Week.
One, two, three, four. Turn it up.
In 1969, Bill France completed what was known as the ultimate super speedway. Alabama International Motor Speedway at Talladega.
We're ready to race right here, right now.
This is the fastest racetrack we've got.
Turn it up.
This is Fox.
Big wheels come on turning.
Welcome to Talladega.
Subway, showing the world how great a fresh sandwich can taste. Subway, eat fresh.
A town so small, host a race so big. Well, today, from Little Talladega, Alabama, population about 20,000, we have one of NASCAR's biggest and fastest races, the Talladega 500, located about 40 miles east of Birmingham, 110 miles west of Atlanta. But race fans know exactly where to find the Talladega Super Speedway. We're expecting about 180,000 people at the track today. That's more than nine times the population of the city in Talladega. And for one day, this town becomes the most populated city in the state. And to give you an idea how big this 2.6-mile track is, you can fit 143 football fields inside the infield here at Talladega. Should be the best race of the year, the Talladega 500 on Fox. Hi, Chris Myers coming to you from our mobile studio just above Victory Circle here at the Talladega Super Speedway. And ever since Daytona, the race buzz from fans and drivers has been about this race and this track because of two things, speed and safety. Here in Alabama, it's a different kind of draft day. The driver that drafts well is likely to be the number one choice at the end of the day. The hottest driver, also the points leader, Dale Jarrett, going for his third straight win. Jeff Gordon said that Jarrett is having a Tiger Woods-like year. Meanwhile, Dodge, which has yet to win a race this year, has the first three spots today. Bill Elliott starting third, Stacy Compton on the pole, Sterling Marlin on the front row, and Michael Waltrip, of course, won the Daytona 500, had to leave that car at the Daytona Museum, but he says he has a better car here today. And we welcome in Darrell Waltrip and, of course, former crew chief Jeff Hammond, four-time winner at this event. You guys ready to go
today? That's my brother, not exactly. My son, by the way.
You got a lock and load here.
Well, we've had this racetrack and these races, and you guys know from your experience here, I mean, great emotion, great drama. And look at the second half, 24 of the cautions in the last eight races, 18 of those have come in the second half, and at least four of the crashes involved 10 cars or more. So we get a crew chief and a driver's perspective. And Darrell, this track rattles you like no other.
Well, I start this race as apprehensive as anything we do. It's so hard to not get in that race car and keep having. I've been here since 1972. Jeff's been here almost that long. I've seen every wreck you can see here. I've been in most of them. One way or another, I made it through a lot of them, but I've been around and involved in most of them. So this place, it makes me very, very nervous.
Yeah, and you don't have to go far, Jeff Hammond, to look at yesterday in the Busch race when the tire came off. Actually, the tread of the tire caused this 13-car pileup. No injuries, though.
No injuries, but it wasn't driver-related. You can't come back and say, hey, the driver made a mistake. The driver made a mistake. He didn't do it. This little bad boy right here creates the most exciting racing you can ever see as far as the fans are concerned. But for a driver and a crew chief, you cannot deal with it because it makes things so unpredictable. You can't do enough to get away from
the
competition.
And you were saying very serious in the garage this morning.
The most somber garage I've ever been in my entire career. The guys there are very tense. They're very intent. And they're very, very concerned about today's race.
All right, the focus is on the race. Tony Stewart, who survived the big one at Daytona, he will start seventh today in the Home Depot Pontiac. The former Rookie of the Year, who won more races than anyone last year, is a driver's driver who loves and lives behind the wheel. Tony Stewart into the Hollywood Hotel. Thanks for coming by so close to the race. Appreciate it. Hanging out with the crew chief, former driver. Let me talk to you about, you didn't know what went on before this, but
we've been having a really good time.
We've been having a great time.
Yeah.
He's going to take me for a ride around the track here. You have had success.
No, we didn't either.
At Talladega. What do you like about this track?
Nothing, to be honest.
But you like running here.
Actually, I mean, this is just kind of a whole different style of racing that we do four times a year that is different from the racing that we do every week, in my opinion. It's basically just being in a freeway traffic jam running 190 mile an hour is all it is, and all it is 190 mile an hour chess match. So I was a lot better at checkers than chess, so it makes me not real good at a restrictor plate race, but at the same time, it's really fun for the fans. The fans enjoy this stuff, and that's why we all keep coming back and doing it.
And the fans saw you were involved in that crash at Daytona, walked away from that. When you get in the car today, because it's a super speedway, does that enter your mind at all?
No, we've had seven other races in between then and now, and I've been in worse wrecks in sprint cars and midgets in the past than I've ever been in the Winston Cup car so far. And I guess the best thing that happened at Daytona when I hit the wall the first time is it knocked me out. So I don't really remember the rest of the ride. And I think that's God's way of saying you're going to be a part of something that's going to be really big and spectacular, but you don't really need to be a part of it so you can sleep through it.
It might have knocked you conscious. You never know. You just never know.
I don't think it knocked any sense into me, though.
One of the things that I swear, when I first got to know you, and I've known you for a while now, when you ran Indy, and then jumped in the airplane and came down to Charlotte, and you were competitive in both races.
Completed both.
And I said to myself, now, an Indy car is so different than a stock car. How can you do that? How do you make that adjustment so quickly?
I think that was probably the biggest thing I took away from running with USAC in the past. You ran dirt and pavement. You ran Silver Crown cars that weighed 1,400 pounds. You ran sprint cars that weighed 1,200 pounds. Midgets that weighed 900 pounds. You run dirt and pavement, quarter-mile tracks to one-mile tracks, pavement, dirt. You learned how to be versatile, and you didn't get an idea or a feeling of how a race car had to feel. Every race car feels different. It taught you to learn to adapt to each different type of car.
You talk about Indy. I keep hearing rumors. Are you going back?
I'm going back. I am going to go back. I'm going on national
TV.
We are going back to Indy.
You heard it here first.
We're going back to Indy. I'm actually going as a car owner, though. I'm fielding a two-car team. Matt Yoakum's driving the first car, and I haven't got the details figured out yet, but Darrell Waltrip is driving the second car. So,
can I crew chief
one?
You
definitely can crew chief one.
I'm
going to crew chief the first car.
I got to ask something real quickly. Don't you think, I know when I first came into Winston Cup, I was always getting myself in trouble because I was used to running those Saturday night specials. And you had to fight your way out of tracks a lot of times, and you always were in a skirmish with somebody. Don't you think that you brought a little of that to the table from that local hero? Now you're at the national level, and every time you say something, and you say, God, I didn't know everybody was listening.
Well, I guess the thing that's always meant the most to me is at the end of the day, seeing the media people come up and say, boy, you're a breath of fresh air to this sport. And, I guess the fans don't always see everything that happens with what happens in Winston Cup racing, but the media people have seen everything that happens. And when they come and tell you that really means something to you. And, to hear all those people at Bristol when we did what we did there, it made me feel better. I mean, I didn't get any points back. I didn't get any money back. And I ended up having to spend money out of the deal. So I still don't understand where I got justified there. But same time, it made me feel a little bit better. Last year, I'd have been ready to pull a guy out and fight him.
Brake trouble. You had brake trouble. I saw it right away.
I was pumping him the whole
time.
I'll go on national television. I like you. You talk about
you're kissing up to him now.
He was very nice to me at Daytona before I said some other things that came along later. But speaking of that fine with Jeff Gordon, now don't spin me out here, okay? Because fans said that they would pay your fine. You had enough donations, even more than that, and you said I'll match that and give it to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. So what kind of total are we at? Is the money still coming?
Actually, it's still coming in. It's something I'm real proud of. I mean, I've always been involved with Make-A-Wish for even when I was driving midgets and sprint cars, to be honest. So, you know, it meant a lot to me that all the fans cared. And, you know, there's people that didn't like it. Those were the Gordon fans. The people that liked it were the people that don't like Gordon or like us. So the thing that was important about that, I shouldn't have spun him out on pit lane. That was the one thing I did do wrong. But the rest of it, you know, I went from 4th to 26th. I lost probably $45,000 or $50,000 in prize money, and all he got out of it was a cracked bumper about 12 inches tall. So I don't think it hurt him too bad.
All right. Thanks for coming by.
My
we
pleasure.
Appreciate it. All right.
My
be
pleasure.
Safe out there today.
Right.
I'll follow him out to the car. Joe, you're going to go to the booth, right? Okay.
And Jeff, getting out here before he did.
Jeff's going to run the Hollywood Hotel the rest of the way. All right. And not only do the drivers, are they getting ready, but so are the wives and the families. And you saw in the Busch race yesterday, Mrs. McLaughlin cheering on her husband. Coming up, we'll take an inside look at what wives go through on race day, especially at Talladega, as we're getting closer to the start of today's race, and the fans are getting more excited about who they like today.
I thought we were going to have to scrap her down yesterday.
Dale Jarrett, 88, number one, right there. Win the race for Big Dan.
Woo!
Tonight, Beck guest stars on an all-new Futurama. Then, Luann gives a revealing forecast.
The weather used to be the one segment we could watch as a family.
An all-new King of the Hill. And, bet you can't eat a box of baking soda.
Dad's having an fantastic trip.
The Simpsons, plus pet sitting for a neighbor.
Come back here, jelly bean!
Turns catastrophic.
How's the convention?
You would not believe some of the idiots that are here.
An all-new Malcolm. It all starts at 7, 6 Central tonight on Fox.
92.5 XTU, Philadelphia's country station.
This is country.
Man, I feel like a woman. Baby, I love you.
This is country. This is Philadelphia country.
92.5 XTU, home of Harmon and Evans. Try them tomorrow morning. 92.5 XTU.
You've got a lot to show for all your hard work. It's time to reward yourself. We've got just what you need. Long-lasting Chevy trucks. Now lease a 2001 Blazer LS four-door, four-wheel drive for as low as $299 a month with $1,934 due at signing. Residency restrictions apply. Call for lease details. That's $299 a month on Blazer. So get out there and make your money count at your Chevy dealer today.
Inside the live racing action with RaceCast. Any driver, every lap. Only at NASCAR.com. America Online keyword, NASCAR.
Beyond the Glory looks back at the life of one of NASCAR's greatest legends, Dale Earnhardt. Beyond the Glory, tonight at 8 on Fox Sports Net.
Welcome back to the Subway Pre-Race Show.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Good San Luis, healthy too, and you needed to be healthy in yesterday's Busch race, the Subway 300. That's Kevin Harvick. He came in as the Busch points leader. Lap 87 here. David Green tread off his tire. It's kind of a Bill Clinton move. He goes left. Everybody else gets in trouble to the right. 13 cars, a third of the field pile up. No injuries as you get an in-car view with Jeff Purvis. And that's the wife of Katie McLaughlin. Actually, an in-car view with Mike McLaughlin, who there in the 20 car holds off Jimmy Spencer. Although not sponsored, to win the race, the McLaughlin group should actually sponsor his car. His wife thrilled, excited after going through a
a high-stress afternoon, and there is Mike McLaughlin with the victory. And it was a victory that Jimmy Spencer was not thrilled about, even though the McLaughlin group was celebrating.
I'll tell you what, Mike McLaughlin drove a very dirty race. He won, though, but I don't forget.
You were pointing fingers at someone. Was that Todd Bodine?
Well, he's supposed to be my teammate, and you saw what the hell he did, too. But that's fine, you know, because Jimmy Spencer never forgets.
Oh, all right, hopefully you heard the music in the background. As I mentioned yesterday, Spencer sounded a little like Tony Soprano. Next week at the Busch Race at California Speedway in Fontana, we'll see if someone will get rubbed out or maybe spun out. Matt Kenseth, by the way, has won the last two Busch races in California. You saw it yesterday's Busch race. Katie McLaughlin, as we showed you, nervously watching her husband Mike hold on to win his first race in 3 years. And while wives and family members are always concerned about the drivers, here at Talladega, they are most concerned. Let's go down to Jeannie Zelasco, who has more. Jeannie?
Well, Chris, to love, honor, and worry a whole lot. It may not be part of the wedding vow, but maybe it should be if you're going to marry a driver. Stevie Waltrip said the first peaceful Sunday morning she had in years was at the start of the season. You know why? Because she knew her husband, Daryl, was safe in the broadcast booth and not behind the wheel of a car. Every other wife out here can relate.
Love that happened.
It was weird because I had no idea what he did. And then when I met him, all we did is really, we talked on the phone. The first time I called him, I was real embarrassed. It was Daytona. You know, everybody knows Daytona. I had no idea. So I called him, leave a message, and I turn on the TV, and there he is. I'm like, what an idiot, you know? He told me after the wedding, he said, I'm going to take you to Atlanta for your honeymoon. Is that okay? And I said, no, I've been there before.
Gordon got loose in Harvick by inches.
And after he won, I said, that was the best wedding present you could have ever given me.
Do you talk to him much during the race?
No, never.
Why not?
No, I would never do that. Because, you know, they have to have so much concentration. They have to be focused on everything they do. And so I would never want to break his concentration. Say, you know, honey, are we going to go grocery shopping tonight?
Don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing, mama.
But this is a dangerous sport, and this week we're at one of NASCAR's fastest and most dangerous tracks.
I hated the Talladega race. I thought it was miserable. I was very thankful at the end that there wasn't a wreck, but I don't know how that there wasn't. I think it's terrible. I hate to go there.
I do not like going to Daytona, and I do not like going to Talladega because they go too fast. They just do.
It's always made me nervous. You know, because they are going at such high speeds and the big packs of cars make it even more, you know, frightening event. It's great for the fans, but maybe it's not so great for the relatives to watch because, you know, that's your heart and soul out there and you don't want a little, you know, anything to go wrong. And so it is nerve-wracking and scary for the wives.
It can be scary, so some of the wives have special routines to help them get through it.
I guess for about 5 years now, I've been putting a Bible verse in Jeff's car, and he tapes it on his steering wheel, and he looks at it during the caution flag laps, and it helps him, and it helps me as well.
I always see Jeff before the race, and we always do the same thing. We always say the same thing, and he always waves to me on the pace lap, and I always wave to him back. So I guess that gives you a comfort level.
Well, and as the saying goes, behind every good man is a great woman. And a lot of these great wives see their husband's fame as an opportunity to help others, like Kelly Jarrett, who raises money for breast cancer awareness. And what about, of course, Jeff Gordon's wife, Brooke Gordon, the muscle behind the Jeff Gordon Foundation, Chris?
Behind every successful driver, there is a woman nervously watching. Jeff Gordon starting 13th. Brooke Gordon, hope that's a lucky number. The race just seconds away. Thank you.
Some students will do anything to be accepted.
The kids who come from money, they're more popular.
But will one girl go too far?
It's a job.
You're going to be ashamed of this.
All new Boston Public, 8, 7 Central tomorrow on Fox. Parental discretion advised. They've been abused by real-life drill instructors.
Shut your mouth!
Now a recruit reaches her breaking point and faces off with the one man who pushed her over the edge. A shocking boot camp, all new at 9, 8 Central, Fox Wednesday.
It's about compassion.
Get out!
Seinfeld, weeknights at 7:30.
Controversial gene research has led scientists to unlock the secrets of DNA. What they've discovered is something many of us have suspected all along. This is the mother of all trucks. Now get 0% financing and a $1,000 cash allowance on Dodge Ram 1500.
Minutes, 2 seconds. Pretty darn good.
See how it's really done May 19th and 20th at Nazareth Speedway as the NASCAR Busch Series pulls into town. For tickets, call 1-888-629-RACE. Nazareth Speedway. Get in the car and go.
Get inside the official gear of NASCAR. Apparel, collectibles, and more. Only at NASCAR.com. America Online keyword, NASCAR.
Welcome back to the Subway Pre-Race Show and Talladega, home of the International Motorsports Hall of Fame. Darrell Waltrip's number 11 car, which he won the Winston Cup Championship with back in 1985, will be going to England with DW in July for a classical car show and race in London. Meanwhile, Dale Earnhardt Jr. revealing his new paint scheme for the All-Star Game. The MBNA All-Star was last week's winner, actually a couple of weeks ago at Martinsville. Dale Jarrett in his UPS car with his third win in four races. Dale, the points leader and threatening with possibly running away from things if he were to have a big performance today. Speaking of All-Stars,
secret, Jeff. I think unity and consistency. We kind of approach the race just like a driver. We don't try to win the race in the first pit stop. We want to stay focused. If something bad happens, the next time we're going to come back and make up for it.
I think it's the go slow to go fast. We don't want to try to do the fastest stop, but we want to be consistent and do good stops all day.
It's really good teamwork.
Yes.
Yeah, we try to be 14 seconds all day. That's our goal. And you know, it comes down to that last stop. So let's take these boys to school. Let's show them how it's done all day long.
Well, take them to school is what it's all about. These guys know how to get it done. And they get an A-plus for their efforts so far this year.
A terrific group of guys who've done a great job for Dale Jarrett and UPS. So we go from the points leader, Dale Jarrett, to the oldest active driver in the Winston Cup Series, Dave Marcus at age 60. But if you think about the oldest drivers ever in Winston Cup, Jim Fitzgerald and Herschel McGriff were actually behind the wheel at age 66. The last Dodge to win at Talladega, driven by Marcus in 76. He was in disco shoes then. Now he's with our Dick Berggren.
The man in the wingtip shoes, Dave Marcus. More experience here at Talladega than anybody else. 60 starts a win in 1976. Three poles. What have you learned about this place, Dave?
Well, it's a very demanding racetrack. We run around here flat foot every lap, and I've had some great finishes here over the years, and it's an exciting place to race. It's going to be very hot today. I think on long runs, the tires are going to get a little bit greasy maybe, and it's going to be an exciting race.
Wish you good luck today.
Thank you.
To Matt Yocum.
And Dick, Jeff Gordon will try for his third Talladega victory, but making things even more difficult for your spotter. New colors again this week for the second time this year.
Well, I got the best spotter out there, so I'm sure he can do it. But yeah, this is exciting for us. You know, Pepsi's been a great supporter of ours for a long time, and it's nice the DuPont folks to let them come on board and share this weekend with them. And it's still the DuPont Chevrolet, but it's just exciting. You know, we had the Pepsi car in the Busch Series, been successful with that, and we hope to be just as successful today here at Talladega.
Circumstances always dictate your game plan here. What is your early game plan?
Game plan. You know, I think that just trying not to do anything, you know, really out of the ordinary. Just try to get yourself in position, see what the car, how the car is working. We've got 188 laps to win this thing today, and you know, it's really going to be won on the last lap. So if you're not there at the end, that doesn't count. But you know, we just got to kind of see what our fuel mileage is, things like that, you know, because if we do have green flag stops, this is going to be real important.
Well, he will try to defend his win in this event, Steve, starting in 13th.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, Mark Martin has been very honest about his feelings that he doesn't particularly care for restrictor plate racing. Mark, here we are at Talladega. Your thoughts as you get ready for this 500-mile race?
Well, we have a really good car this week. We qualified well. It's pretty fast on the racetrack with the other guys. And the only the bad thing about that is that it doesn't matter how fast your car is, you're always going to get shuffled back. And you know, you just have to be in the right place at the right time to be in these wrecks. And I hope I'm maybe in, you know, some other position, or ultimately if we can get through this thing without having, you know, those kind of accidents. 43 car drafts are awfully hard to keep going for 500 miles.
Best of luck, Mark. Let's go back to Chris Myers.
All right, thanks, Steve and Mark. Let's go up to the broadcast booth and get our predictions from Larry and Darrell. Gentlemen.
Driver, who you like?
Well, I'm going to take Dale Jr. Finished second at Daytona. I keep thinking he's going to win a race. I keep thinking Sterling is too, but I'm going to take Dale Jr. today.
All right, I'm hesitant to call it a long shot. 201 races since his last win, but I'm going to go with a man that qualified third, Bill Elliott in that Dodge.
Good pick.
Jeff, what do you think?
Right now, what I'm looking at is the last man standing. But since I got to kind of go out on line even further than what Larry did, I'm going to pick Jeremy Mayfield, who's starting way in the back today.
All right, let's check it out. At least you're going out on a limb. Those other guys going with the big names. And Larry McReynolds, at the moment, we're measuring average finish, is what has you in front. He's in front of Darrell Walter of the Hollywood Hotel, Jeff Hammond. We are last at the moment, but we'll try and change that. Jeff and I will be here all afternoon to watch the race with you. Thanks for being with us. Great race in a great place. The Talladega 500 is next. It's music to our ears and yours too.
Oh, I come from Alabama with my banjo on my knee. Today on Fox and the fastest track, a race odyssey. Dale Jarrett leads in points, that boy sure can fly. Chris Myers, he's a pretty boy, oh Chrissy, don't you cry. Oh, Jeff Gordon, you're the one I want to see. You won this race a year ago, beating you is still the king. Talladega has some history, this track's a scary sight. Even though he stuffs his face all day, Jeff Hammond, he's all right. Well, the race is next and I can't wait, we'll go up to the booth. Mike, Larry, and D.W., these guys have no clue. Oh, Fox announcers, don't get mad at me. We're just messing with y'all, Fox is the place to be.
The Talladega 500 is next on Fox!
Unfolds on Talk Network. Fox.
Think Fox First with Don Tollefson on the Fox 10 o'clock news.
Pocono. This is the track known for its awesome restarts, incredible high speeds, long straightaways with three demanding turns, and a fan favorite pit paddock pass that puts you near all the action. The stars of NASCAR invade Pocono Raceway twice this year. June 17th, it's the Pocono 500 with a post-race concert by Billy Ray Cyrus. And July 29th, it's the Pennsylvania 500 with a post-race concert by Travis Tritt. So call now, 1-800-RACEWAY. That's 1-800-RACEWAY. Operators standing by.
Looks like you got a little nick there.
What, this?
It's nothing.
maybe we should get it looked at.
Or maybe we should go get a delicious Mike's Hard Lemonade instead.
You're on.
A hard day calls for a hard lemonade. Make it Mike's.
On April 27th, get ready.
Do you like water?
It's my second favorite thing in the world.
And what's your first favorite?
For the sexiest.
Would anybody care for another burger?
I'll have a hot dog if you have one.
Funniest.
How come you never wear a uniform? I bet you look real good in it.
Smartest comedy of the spring.
I gotta admit, she's not perfect.
How not perfect can one woman be?
One Night at McCool's.
What's going on?
It's not what it looks like.
Rated R. Starts Friday.
Jamie Bohan owns a Hyundai Sonata.
We looked at consumer ratings and all of the features that came with the vehicle.
This is Jamie's second Hyundai.
It's very luxurious. It's very dependable.
It comes with the freedom of America's best warranty and more standard features than Camry or Accord.
It's a really fun car to drive because the engine is very powerful.
The Hyundai Sonata. At $15,799, it's a lot more car. Freedom is calling, yeah. Right now, get special 0.9% financing on the Sonata. Hurry in.
The fastest network on Earth welcomes you to the fastest speedway on Earth. 2.66 miles around, 36 degree banked. They'll run 4 and 5 wide today, and that's what's brought nearly 180,000 fans to Talladega, Alabama for the 9th NASCAR Winston Cup race of 2001. Today on Fox, it's the Talladega 500, presented by Subway. A huge crowd on hand for the 9th race of 2001. And after 8 races, Dale Jarrett leads the point standings over Jeff Gordon, Johnny Benson, and Sterling Marlin, tied for 3rd, and Steve Park, the Rockingham winner, rounding out the top 5. If you watch the Daytona 500, this will be similar, but different. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Talladega. Mike Joy with 3-time Winston Cup champ Darrell Waltrip and Larry McReynolds. This will be about as fast. It's wider, so it'll be more competitive. It'll be more nail-biting. And, Darrell, is this the nerve-wrackingest race of the first half of the year?
You know, when you said nerve-biting, you're not kidding. Even up here, I watched this thing from up here. Folks, I've seen these cars. I've seen them hit the wall. I've seen them go over the wall. I've seen about everything you can see here. And this place really does make the drivers nervous. There's not a guy down there. They can't tell the crew chief. They can't tell us. But I can tell you, having been there, these guys are really, really tense today. It's a different kind of racing than normally run.
We're all worried about the big one, the big crash, and we had one yesterday. Larry, is it a question of if or a question of when?
Well, I think the big question is when, but we also know that it might not just be a driver error. It could be a mechanical failure like we saw in the Busch Grand National race. But standing on top of that pit box for 20 years, strategy. I've always been torn between what to tell that driver. You preach patience, but I know in that last 25 to 30 laps, you say, look, no more deals, no more buddies, let's get to the front.
This race will take your breath. Let's go trackside for today's opening ceremonies.
Almighty God, we thank you for this beautiful part of the world, for all of these race fans gathered here, and for all of the athletes, the drivers, and all who make this race possible. We thank thee for this great gathering of your people, and we stop to say that you are our God, and we are your children, and bless the activities this day. Shalom and amen.
Remain standing for our national anthem, tribute music, and racing fans, Ricochet.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Now, once again, the Grand Marshal of today's Talladega 500, Randy Owen.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
For 188 white knuckle laps at the world's fastest speedway. Let's go down to the starting grid and Speedway Illustrated's Dick Bergren.
Thanks, Mike. The headline today is speed and fear. In the wake of recent tragedies, today they will travel together in frightening packs, racing three and four wide at over 180 miles an hour. The goal of every team, miss the big one, the wreck with a dozen or more cars. Right now, the drivers and crews are trying to put fear aside, concentrate, and hope to be lucky enough to have a chance to win at the end of the race. But all want this most, that at the end of the day, every driver will walk away.
Well, I mean, it's this is our biggest and fastest racetrack, and it should install a little bit of fear into everybody.
I mean, if you lose focus for one lap or if you lose focus for 1 second, you know, you're right in the middle of a pack of 43 cars and you can take out 40 cars.
It takes an unbelievable amount of concentration here at Talladega. You don't have any room. The cars are compacted all around you. You're just at the mercy of really who's around you.
You know how intense and everything that you put into it. When the checkered falls, if you're fifth or tenth or seventh or if you win, you just say, yes. You know, I gave it all I had on this day, and I got what I got.
There's a lot on the line at every auto race. Today, there's more on the line than at most. To Matt Yoakum.
Dick, Dale Earnhardt was the most prolific restrictor plate driver in NASCAR history with 11 wins and only 53 plate races. No one will ever replace the man in black, but someone will fill his restrictor plate role as the guy to follow all the way to the front. So who will be the new go-to guy? Dale Jarrett or Jeff Gordon? They've combined for 11 plate wins. Or will someone new step forward? It's a question that at day's end could still be left unanswered. To Steve Burns.
Matt, when this massive racetrack opened in 1969, Dodge finished 1, 2, and 3 in the very first race. But NASCAR hasn't seen a Dodge in victory lane since 1977 when Neil Bonnet pulled off a victory. But today, Dodge starts 1, 2, 3, led by Stacy Compton, Sterling Marlin, and Bill Elliott. Can one of these three drivers bring Dodge back to victory lane for the first time in 24 years? To Genie Zelasco.
Well, Steve, Michael Waltrip says he will take every single bit of information he gained in Daytona and apply it here at Talladega. That's a good thing, considering he is the Daytona 500 champion. So he did have to leave that winning car behind at Daytona USA, but he left with something more important, knowledge. Knowledge that the 15 team poured into this car. They are feeling confident, and Mike Joy hoping that they can live up to the expectations of being the Daytona 500 champion.
Thank you, Jeannie. The cars begin to roll as on Fox. From Talladega, we get set to show you life on the fastest track.
I'm a traveling man, made a lot of stops all over the world, and in every port I own a heart and at least one lovely girl. Man.
short time can make a lifetime of difference, because kids with something to do are less likely to do drugs.
Standing right in front of them.
You can help. Call toll-free 1-877-KIDS-313 to find out about community drug prevention programs.
I can keep a kid off drugs.
It may be the beginning of life. It may be the end of the world.
This isn't about the X-Files, Scully. It's only about you.
Get ready for the season's final five episodes, leading to the most shocking moment of all.
Push, Dana, push!
The X-Files, all new, starting at 9, 8 central tonight on Fox.
They were designed to be the perfect killing machines.
Yesterday, a body was found in the woods outside of the city, had a barcode on his neck.
Now, one is on a rampage, and the only way Max can stop him is to reveal her past.
What's going on? What are you not telling me?
Dark Angel, all new at 9, 8 central, Fox Tuesday.
The safety workers salute the drivers as they come by on one of the pace laps. Crowd is all filed into the seats, and most all of them are full, certainly on the front stretch, and all but the lowest seats on the back straightaway. Budweiser, official beer of NASCAR, proud sponsor of the Bud Pole Award for the fastest qualifier at each Winston Cup race. Stacy Compton is today's Bud Pole winner. Since 1979, more than $7 million has been awarded to Bud Pole program winners. So here's a look at our subway starting grid for today's race. Compton and Marlin are the two Ernie Elliott-powered Dodges up there on the front row.
Yeah, I thought I would have picked Sterling second here last time, but I don't know. We'll see what happens.
Bill Elliott, he'll start third, has won here twice, once made two laps up under green to come back and win.
I was here for that.
Ricky Craven passed in yesterday's practice.
Mark Martin inside the third row. Two wins here included in his 18 Talladega top 10 finishes.
And Tony Stewart, he could be somebody to watch today. Shakes off that Daytona crash and has at it.
Kevin Harvick, Atlanta winner. Joe Nemechek, third here last October.
Mike Skinner, he'll start 12th. Career best finish of second 1 year ago.
You don't have to start up front. Jeff Gordon won from 36th there last year.
Yes, he did. And the only thing is, he don't have any flames. If he had flames, I'd be thinking he'd be great today.
Dave Marcus, Mr. Wingtips, first race of 2001 season, 61st Talladega race start.
Steve Park, Kevin LePage there.
My pick, Dale Jr., go young man.
Jeff Burton, best finish here, was 7th in 14 races.
Andy Houston there next to Brett Bodine. Andy's never raced here till today.
There's Rusty Wallace. He was 3rd at Daytona, and he's pretty competent.
Kurt Busch is also seeing Talladega for the very first time. Buckshot Jones, or rather John Andretti there with Bobby Hamilton. Presley, Todd Bodine.
There's Jimmy Spencer. Now, he has won here. Back in 1994, had a great run yesterday in the Busch race.
Ken Schrader, he's a former winner back in 1988 here.
Johnny Benson, best restrictor plate result in 20 races, is 9th here at Talladega.
And there's Ward Burton. We don't know how good his car is because he didn't get to qualify. Had some sort of problem. He didn't get to make a run.
Jeff Hammonds picked Jeremy Mayfield out back there. He was last year's pole winner for this race. Rookie Ron Hornaday. And Mike Wallace, who was 6th at Daytona, completes the 43-car field. Kyle Petty did not qualify for today's race, nor did Kenny Wallace, and the only Alabama driver to attempt, Hutch Strickland, Andy Hillenburg from Indiana, and Rick Mast from Virginia, also had to head home. First race Kenny Wallace has missed in 5 years. Over $3.8 million in posted awards, including season-ending point money. The 500 miles will consume 188 laps. And every 50 or 55 laps, they're going to need fuel and tires.
And most of the time, it will be two tires.
So get set as we go racing on Fox on the fastest speedway on Earth. It's coming at you next.
Get inside the nonstop action on race weekend. Get inside the news and highlights. Get inside the teams, fans, and games. Only at the official site of NASCAR. NASCAR.com. America Online keyword, NASCAR.
And there's a double for
no places.
Jeff explains bump drafting. Mike talks restrictor plates. They talk about how the drivers have all got what it takes. DW's talking rounds and bite. Mac Reynolds talking loose. The train is running three cars wide from engine to caboose. This is Talladega. Tighten down your shocks. This is Talladega, as covered by the Fox. Let's go racing!
Yeah.
All right, then, let's go racing, and we will in one lap. Now, today's weather is just dead solid perfect. 79 degrees, track temperature 104, light humidity, moderate wind.
And I got to believe that's going to stay pretty consistent. A few clouds in the sky, and so I look for this to stay pretty consistent.
Yeah, it's a pretty warm day from a driver's perspective, but they've all got the cool boxes in, blows cool air in the helmets. That's to keep their heads cool, and they're going to need that all day long.
Darrell, I've got to ask, the memory of Daytona is fresh in everyone's mind in this field. Would you want to be up front, or would you want to hang back in, say, these first 100 or so miles?
Mike, I'll wreck you to stay up front. I mean, I'll run you down in the grass to stay up front, because that's the safest place to be. But if I get shuffled to the back, I'm going to watch them wreck you trying to stay up front.
Okay. Darrell, do you want your car up? You want your car in the midst of all that?
I want my car at the front. I'm going to do everything I can on pit road to make the right strategy calls. Anything we can do, working with the spotter, working with anybody to keep that car at the front of the field.
But Darrell, there's 43 guys who want to be in the front, and 30 of them are capable of being there.
It's what I always call the eye of the storm. You don't want to be in the eye. You want to be in the fringes of it. But
okay,
don't get caught up in the middle, because that's where the action is.
Dick Berggren.
The fast way around Talladega is at the bottom. The closer to the bottom, the better. But this morning in the drivers' meeting, Mike Helton warned the drivers, do not cross that yellow line, because if you do, you are at risk of a black flag. Lots of the Busch Series drivers did it yesterday, running below the white line they were just talked to. Today, it'll be the black flag if NASCAR decides they're running too low.
You're right, Dick. Can't do that in the corners because of the transition from the 36-degree banking to the flat apron. But down the back straightaway, we saw them everywhere, but in the grass yesterday.
And that's what gets you in trouble here. When you get four wide going into the turn, the guy on the inside will always clip that apron with that left front wheel, and it'll make his car run up the racetrack. When he does, he gets into the guy beside him, and that sets off a chain reaction.
From pace car speed, how long will it take to get everyone up to race pace?
Oh, the guys in the front, they'll get going, and, you know, the first lap, they'll be 51 seconds. The next lap, they'll be 50 seconds, and then they'll be down into 49 seconds. So 185, 190, and then 190 and above once they get sorted out.
Five lanes wide and banked steeper in the corners than the roof of your house. The widest, fastest, steepest super speedway on earth.
It all seems so easy here, so easy, but it happens so fast.
Okay, pull your belts tight, spotter, take care of them. You got two spotters here, one on the front stretch, one on the back stretch. Long way down to this start finish line, not here in a trial, but like at Daytona, all the way headed down the short chute into turn one, green flag coming.
Darrell, are you hopeful or nervous?
Well, right now you're just real tentative. You don't know what to expect. You don't know what your car's going to do. You just like to get going, shake off those butterflies, get into a rhythm, and then start racing.
Green flag, and Stacy Compton steps out with a lead.
Big lead here can be good, but it can be bad. They get a run on you, get out there too far.
And you know, it doesn't take very long in a race like this to find out what kind of day you're going to have. Are the drivers going to respect each other? Are they going to give and take? Or is it going to be wild and rowdy right from the get-go?
Well, it's at least three wide already.
Four wide. That didn't take long.
No. Four wide into the corner.
And again, this is not Daytona. This is Talladega. Even though they are called similar racetracks, they're totally different. They race totally different.
Ricky Craven in the 32 car there burned a piston in his motor late in practice yesterday. They was driving the car around the garage area this morning just making sure the clutch and everything worked good.
Four wide through the trioval, now down to three abreast.
The trickiest part of this racetrack is through the trioval. For the guy on the inside, when they're four wide, he gets those left side wheels again down on that flat. It can upset the car and shoot him right into the guy beside him. right now you're pretty comfortable. They're coming up to speed. They're still gaining speed every lap. That time by, they were 50-40. And as they get going here, they'll be down into 49 seconds.
It just shows you how much the draft means. Stacy Compton sat on the pole at a 51.80, about 2 seconds quicker in the draft.
Five cars on the inside line in front trying to break away as we come to lap three and we'll honor Dale Earnhardt's memory.
Sterling has had the best Dodge all year long, week in, week out, and he leads again this week, and he's led every race. That car is going to win a race.
Looks like Stacy Compton, our pole sitter there in the middle in the 92 car, he was odd man out on this session right here. He gets back in line just in front of Andy Houston.
Well, what a lot, truck man. Mates, you know, they race trucks together. Gave him a break, let him in. That's what you want to see early in the race particularly. Like to see it all day long, but early on.
How about the 01 right there? That's Jason Leffler. He's moved up from 23rd position, 25th position. It's a good run for him.
Coming from the back here is easy. You got all those cars to graft on. You got all those cars to suck you right up there like a big vacuum cleaner. That thing, they get a hold of you, they pull you up there, and you've got to go.
Yeah, sucking up here has nothing to do with corporate politeness.
No, it doesn't.
It's catching the draft and using it to suck your car up to the group ahead. Two rookies and an open wheel veteran there, three abreast.
25 with you, clear all around.
And it looks so sanitary. Three wide, nice even spaced lines. Everybody minding their own business.
Car, he started third, got kicked back, working the high side there. He's going to get in line right here. Didn't have a lot of help up there, but he gets back in front of the 29 car, Kevin Harvick.
But look at the log jam right behind this single file group where still Leffler leads the middle lane. Blaney on the high side, 93, and a big jam up behind him. Oh, Blaney got a little loose there, slid up the racetrack.
What you'll see here at Talladega, time and time again, the guys in the back will work their way right to the front. The guys in the front will work themselves to the back. But that'll go on all day long, backers and forth, backers and forth.
Well, we're looking out the front of Ron Horner right here, the 14 car. This just tells you where you start does not mean a whole lot at Talladega. He started 42nd. He is 17th now.
Looking back at Mike Wallace from
Horner. Two back two.
Right now is when your crew chief is calling in and asking.
Two back two, the seven ain't gonna leave us. He's gonna stay right with us now.
Oop, three wide, Casey Atwood, the rookie.
It's Gordon down there on the bottom, easing on by. They'll be calling in and asking about the gauges because they run a few laps here in traffic. How's your temperatures? So that they can start thinking about the tape. How's your car? Is there anything we need to do right away? If anything.
Three wide. Three wide. Two wide.
Yes, Casey Atwood fought his way up through there. That's his red number 19 moving up the outside.
There's no question about it. You can get, if you get help, there is no slow line. You get help in the middle, you're going to go forward through the middle. Get help on the outside, you can make that outside work.
Pole sitter Compton, 92, has drifted back right about midfield.
today in that green 14 car. Boy, he is on the move. He's all the way up now to 12th.
And there's no real panic right now. Doesn't matter really what's going on. Just stay out of trouble. Work on your car. Concentrate. Try to give the crew some information, things they can use that'll make you better later on in the day. We got 500 miles here.
Sterling Marlin leads Bill Elliott, two Dodges out front. Let's go to Steve Burns.
Mike, that's the very same Dodge that Sterling Marlin drove to a seventh place finish at the Daytona 500. The team built a new car for this racetrack, but they decided the Daytona 500 car was better. And when NASCAR made a rule change to raise that air deflector across the roof of the car, crew chief Lee McCall said it just made him mad. They just wanted to work harder to get this car ready for the race.
We thought that rule change would slow down the Dodges, but they took the first three qualifying spots, and they lead this race. Marlin, Elliott, then Mark Martin, Tony Stewart, and Michael Waltrip are the top five, but the whole pack is in one long draft coming off turn four. That's the way they run here at Talladega. We'll be right back to the fastest speedway on Earth on Fox.
Scusi?
All right then, next stop, Scusi. Chop chop, presto!
Subway introduces two new fresh baked gourmet breads. Delicious Asiago cheese with real Asiago cheese baked on top. And tasty country wheat with rolled oats, poppy seeds, and more. Two new gourmet breads at Subway.
Stroke! 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 Stroke!
Subway. Eat fresh.
If you could use some help, Labor Ready makes finding it easy. Just call 1-800-24-LABOR or go to laborready.com. Order anytime, the day before or an hour before. No interviewing, no paperwork, no hassles. And with over 800 offices across the U.S. and Canada, there's a Labor Ready near you. You can find good help these days. Labor Ready, dependable temporary labor.
If your house could talk, what would it say?
I've been around a long time, and you know why? Because I was built to last.
Only Lowe's has top choice lumber, prime grade lumber that's center cut.
I always said, use the best wood. You'll be around forever.
With top choice lumber, you get four clean sides that fit together like a dream.
Come see me in the next century. I'll be here.
Lowe's, improving home improvement.
It's not for sale. No.
Some things are just too good to let go of. That's why there's Valvoline Max Life, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines. Max Life conditions use seals to help prevent leaks and helps you hold on to your car for a long, long time.
Don't even think about it.
Valvoline Max Life. And for a simple way to keep your tires looking great, use Eagle One Wet Tire Shine.
The Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox, is brought to you by Subway, showing the world how great a fresh sandwich can taste. Subway, fresh. By Labor Ready, dependable temporary labor guaranteed. By Lowe's Home Improvement Warehouse, Lowe's improving home improvement. And by Fram, pay a little more now or pay a lot later.
Coming around to complete 12 laps at the Talladega Super Speedway.
Man, is that all?
I know, it only seems like 100, Darrell.
I thought we'd been racing. It's a couple hundred laps here.
It's because you've been holding your breath for that long. Now, Sterling Marlin leads the race. Michael Waltrip leads the group in the outside. Kevin Harvick right with him. And Andy Houston, the rookie.
Some guys are really starting to move each other around. Some of these guys are, you know, 12, 15 laps, and cars have come around. They're starting to make some pretty bold moves.
Except for tail end Charlie.
Oh, Lonesome Sam there. But let me tell you, my hot rod was as fast as his, I'd be right where he is.
Matt, what's the story on Dale Jarrett?
Same game plan as Daytona, Mike. Drop to the back and ride. Todd Parrott told me this morning that's going to be the game plan. He says he figures that DJ needs, after the final practice session, they learned he needs about 10 laps to go from the back to the front. So right now, they said their race is two sections, the start and 60 laps to go.
And you see that Jarrett's speed is right on pace with the leader. Remember here last October, Dale Earnhardt made what I consider one of the greatest comebacks in the history of all sports, coming from 18th to win in three laps.
But with this aerodynamic package and with everybody kind of trying to protect the lead, you can come from the back, you can take them by surprise, and that's what happens when you're coming up on them and they don't know where you come from.
And what we mean by the new aerodynamic package, what it's doing, it's poking a bigger hole in the air, dirtying the air up, and enables a car to pull back up, or a pack of cars to pull back up. Until they did this with the roof in and the spoiler, you could not pull back. We pretty much knew who was going to win the race 10, 15 laps to go. Nobody could pass.
We know Dale Jarrett's strategy in the back, but how about these cars up front? Jeannie?
Well, how about Tony Stewart, the strategy or lack thereof? He says he doesn't plan anything because there are 42 other guys planning something that they're going to do. No matter what you do, it's going to ruin what you're planning. He said, I've never had a plan. I had one plan the very first time I came here, and it grenaded on the second lap, so I'm not going to worry about plans anymore. I'm just going to drive, guys.
Is he right, Darrell? Do you have to be more reactive here than proactive?
Well, right now, the guys up front there, they're happy. There's nobody trying to pull out, nobody trying to pass. Sterling and Bill are running nose to tail. You got Mark right there, and Tony. Those guys, kind of, if they can stay hooked up that way, protect that lead, they're tickled to death to look back and see all those guys side by side.
Jeff Gordon trying to move up into the top 10 as you look from the back of the DuPont Pepsi Chevy.
Outside,
that's Ward Burton right
outside,
behind
him. Outside,
looking at Ward Burton on Friday in qualifying, his car never made it off pit road. He had to use a provisional, started 39th. And he has moved all the way up to the 13th position. Felt like they had a pretty fast race car, just didn't get to qualify.
Biggest mover, seventh place, Ron Hornaday. Started 42nd, and he is up to seventh. Boy, things shook out behind Casey Atwood. He got a little loose there going into turn one.
I've been watching this car. It's jumping around a lot on him, and it just jumped right out from under him then, sideways. And that's how you get in trouble here with everybody around you.
Darrell, when we see that happen, is it more apt to be mechanical or aerodynamic?
No, it's aerodynamics. It just lifts the thing up. You run such aggressive stock package, you make these cars fast. When they get a little air around them, get them upset, they'll jump up in the air and turn sideways.
That has allowed about a dozen cars a little bit of breathing room on the field.
And, Mike, I'm not kidding. They literally jump up in the air. The wheels will come off the ground with so much rebound in the shocks.
These guys, they've got to where they don't even change their cars from how they got them on the ground the best they can from qualifying the race. You want it to stay on the ground. Run as fast as you can on the straightaways. Look at Ron Hornaday in that 14 car up at the high side by himself.
He's going to come from the last row to the first row.
Yeah, he's got some ponies under the hood today.
Two by two, you got help coming.
Got a little bit of help coming. You hear the spotter tell him, got help coming from Stacy Compton. The pole sitter moves to the outside, though.
Well, if your coach and car owner was A.J. Foyt, wouldn't you be running to the front?
I'd really, yeah, get up front or else going to have to deal with super techs, and I wouldn't want to do that. 43 cars out here ain't nothing compared to dealing with him.
You know, 12 cars got a little bit away when Casey Atwood had his bobble, but they've all accordioned right back into one pack again.
Well, these cars have now what they call the closing rate. They close up so fast. There's such a hole being shot, pushed in the air by all this aerodynamic stuff that it allows the car behind to really, really close up in a hurry.
And a lot of time when they do that, Darrell, they won't actually back off the throttle. They reach up there and touch the brake pedal.
Boy, Atwood is, that car is all over the place.
He needs to go back there and visit.
So coming outside, and we're coming three wide right there.
Riding with Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Watch this 19 car. He's bouncing around, hopping around. He sticks it down in there. Whoa, I'm wobbling, I'm weaving. Give me some room. Boy, if John Andretti hadn't let him in, that could have been a wreck.
Boy, it had all the ingredients of one.
That's a rookie right in front of a good veteran that knew what to do.
This car is actually the car that Bill Elliott sat on the pole with at Daytona and finished fifth. Casey inherited it for here at Talladega.
It looks like maybe it's a low drag car. In other words, not a lot of downforce, and it's causing him a lot of trouble in traffic.
Hornaday trying to bust his way through the middle. Buckshot Jones on the outside of him, and he comes through with 33 Joe Nemechek and Casey Atwood.
Really, the front end gets real light as you exit the turns, particularly when you're behind somebody. It takes the air off the nose, and you really have the wheels cut around. And when they bite, sometimes the car will get jukey and jump around with you.
Darrell, what we're seeing, it just looks like the bottom of this racetrack. That's the lane that's moving. We saw it yesterday in the Busch race. Jimmy Spencer on the high side, he just couldn't make that pass. Didn't have a lot of help, but it's like the bottom of the racetrack is the fast way.
And I see that with Ken Schrader. Schrader started 36th in car 36. fought his way up to the top 20, then found himself a place in the bottom lane, an 18th spot, and he sat right there. Hasn't gained, hasn't lost, but in a nice, comfortable spot.
Now, once you find a place where just what you said, you're comfortable, you'd like to stay there until everybody leave me alone. Some of those hand signals we've seen isn't all about passing or anything else about. Just get away and leave me alone.
Well, we got two fast race cars hooked up together, though. Ward Burton in the 22, Ron Hornaday in that 14, started into the rear of the field, and they're all the way breaking into the top 10 right here.
When you're on the outside, you go up to the front and back to the rear, up to the front and back to the rear.
Thousand seats at Talladega, but all they're using is the front edge. 19 laps complete, all green so far in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway.
Four identical cars, four identical engines. Only one running on new Havilland, our latest triumph in Havilland motor oil technology. And what difference does that make? Not only do you get unsurpassed performance, but tests show that with new Havilland under the hood, you get better gas mileage. Havilland. Add more life to your car. Buy 12 quarts of Havilland motor oil and get this die-cast collectible for just $5.99 while they last.
Easy boy.
Would you please get out of the kitchen?
There's no better feeling than that of a job well done. And nothing helps you do the job better than America's number one filter, Fram. There's no better feeling than that of a job well done. And nothing helps you do the job better than America's number one filter, Fram.
Welcome back to Talladega. 22 laps complete in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox. I like that sign.
Yeah.
On Michael Waltrip's dash.
You can hear the engine in that car. Never changes sounds. He's got it wide open all the time. It's turning about 7,000 RPM. Now he squeezed up a little bit thin. Here I see the sound got a little softer. Now he's back in it. And that's what you do. He's probably working the gas
outside,
and the brake together
outside,
to stay right in, tucked 14, in tight
33.
On that 24 car.
Ward Burton up alongside of Gordon, Hornaday next to Waltrip, Earnhardt Jr., Waltrip's teammate right behind. Up front, I wonder, as long as Sterling Marlin and Bill Elliott have the lead, can anybody else get to the front?
Boy, well, Jerry Nadeau, he's bringing this outside line with Ward Burton and Ron Hornaday. They got a good run-up off turn two, D.W.
They did, and they're trying to get out there, and we're not going to have much of a race here until these guys get up here and challenge Sterling and Bill, but they're working their way right up there. Got to stay together. See how Hornaday fell back. That'll hurt them a little bit. What generally happens, they'll get all the way up there, and then one of them will dive down on the inside and leave the rest of them hanging out. You'll work real hard with the guy, get him up there, and then he'll leave you.
Yeah, last October, let's not forget, it was Kenny Wallace drafting in tight tandem with Dale Earnhardt that helped Dale get to the front in those final three laps. From first to last, it's only 3.9 seconds.
Yeah, nobody has fallen out of the lead draft. Everybody's still running right together.
There's old Lonesome Dale.
Great shot. Look at him sitting in there. He just, this arm over here is just kind of got it on the roll bar, kind of holding the thing steady down the straightaway, getting to the turn, tightens up on the steering wheel a little bit. Now watch his head bob around a little bit. Bam, 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 bam. Not the easiest way to make a living.
Sure is a fun one. Matt Yoakam.
The only concern for Dale Jarrett, Mike, about five laps ago, Dale's spotter, Bob Jeffrey, told him, you've got a piece of paper on the grill. So he worked out with Brian Dante and Johnny Benson's spotter, who's also riding back with DJ, if DJ could run up and bump the 10 car to clean the grill. Benson said, sure, just do it on the backstretch. He did. Then Todd Parrott gave him the difference from first to 43rd. DJ said, don't worry about it. It is not a problem. To Dick.
Well, Dale Jarrett's going to have some company back there because pole sitter Stacy Compton has dropped all the way to the back of the pack. Early overheating. They dropped back in order to try and cool things off just a little bit. Right now, the water's down to 180, 220 on the oil. That isn't too bad at all, but he's going to ride around in the back with Dale Jarrett. Try to miss the big one.
In preseason, the Dodge engines, previously untested in Winston Cup, did have overheating difficulties, but it's not been much of a problem since we started the race season.
But we got air temperatures in the mid-80s and probably going to climb as the day goes on. These guys, we run as much tape as we can on the front end. Makes these cars go faster down the straightaway. As long as you can keep that water temperature around 215 to 220 in the draft, all temperature 240, 250, you'll be okay.
Oh, yeah, those engine men will start hollering at you if it gets over 220 because the engine will start to detonate, misfire, and the next thing you know, you've got a failure.
He took the piece of paper off his grill by wiping it off on the car ahead's bumper at 190 miles an hour.
Well, what he did is he ran right up underneath the car, Benson's car. That takes all the air off the front of his car. And with no air pushing on it, it just lets the paper fall right off.
Yeah, he probably never actually had to get up there and touch him.
Got up close to him, and it came right off.
Well, as we said in February, Daytona.
I think it might. Some of it still may be on there.
These are common men doing very uncommon things.
Do whatever it takes when you need to do it.
But we've all learned. We all know what we can and can't do. It's when you go outside that box you get in trouble.
Guys, the six car, Mark Martin, we've not really talked about him. He's got a strategy, it looks like, of trying to stay up front. He started fifth. He was the only Roush car to qualify in the top 20, been sitting there running in the top five since the green flag drop.
That car is as good here as it was not good at Daytona.
Yeah, and again, I make a point about this is not Daytona. I've had cars that won't run a lick at Daytona that fly here. There's something about the racetrack just so totally different.
Listening to Mark Martin's crew chief, Jimmy Fenwick, talked to him just a few laps ago. He radioed Mark and said, how is everything? Everything is fine, Jimmy. I'm just riding. So Mark Martin is very happy with where he is, riding behind Bill Elliott.
Things happen so fast here. The crew chief, we don't say a lot to the drivers. You let those spotters have their ways, because while you're asking him a question or he's answering you, there could be somebody running on the high side fixing the passage. You got to leave it open to the spotters.
The biggest thing I liked about here was, don't bother me about a lot of technical things, but encourage me. Tell me I'm doing a good job. Tell me to stay where I am. Stay in that lead draft. Hang in there, buddy. We got a long way to go. Encouraging the driver is one of the most important things that you can do, particularly when you're at a track like this and tension is so high.
Boy, the bank, and it's like running on the side of a building. But Darrell, you used the word a lot, anticipate. The driver has to anticipate. The spotter has to be a good anticipator as well.
Yeah, he can, you know, normally you can look at a situation and see cars getting together and you can start to anticipate some action. Here you got to anticipate all the way around because they're all over the, you know, they're all bunched up together the way they are.
Steve?
Darrell, you're exactly right. I was listening to Jeff Gordon right before the race started, and all he talked about was to his spotter, Ron Thiel. He said, let me know if I'm getting in a position where I'm going to be three wide. I don't want to be in the middle. Other than that, there has been no communication.
And that's a lot like we talked yesterday. Mike McLaughlin won this race. His spotter, Curtis Markham, former Busch driver. Jeff Gordon's spotter, Ron Thiel Jr., former Busch North driver. To have somebody who's been there and done some of that, that's quite an advantage.
You don't realize, nobody does unless you've been out there. You can push the wrong button, and you can really upset that driver. You can tell him something that he really doesn't need to know, start asking questions that are not important, and the next thing you know, you've got a driver that's irritated. Here, you just need to be you got to know what he needs to hear and keep telling him that.
Well, we've been watching Bobby Hamilton in the 55 car. He's been really working the high side, trying to see. I think there he is right up there at the very top of the racetrack. He's wanting some help up there to see if we can do anything up here, guys.
He's going to run about the Talladega 520 if he stays up there.
He's got help coming with Rusty Wallace in the 2 and Dave Marcus in the 71. This is looking out in front of Rusty, looking toward Bobby Hamilton.
But Darrell, even in the trioval, Hamilton came through here way high up the racetrack.
Well, we've always seen, particularly last couple of years here, there are two distinctive lines. And normally that outside line, if you get enough help, can work its way up to the front. And I tell you, Nate Dew is doing everything he can to pull that outside line right to the lead. He's gained a lot, and he's gaining more every lap.
Working on the outside.
Wallace underneath Presley.
This is going to be the first challenge we've had from anybody on Sterling Marlin since the race started.
That 55 team that Hamilton drives for, they finished second here last October with Kenny Wallace driving. And here comes Nadeau, the little engine that could, it's like, is trying to pull that train up alongside on track two.
Well, he's got some great help. He's got Burton there, and he's got Hornaday. He's got some great help, and they're coming right to the front. Now, the 40 car will do what I think. What you got to do now is play both sides. Watch him. He'll move over to the left and pull the left line up. Here he comes. He's going to keep Bill's right with him. Stay with Bill. Now, move out a little bit. That way you keep those cars behind you side by side.
That's a tough job to do, though, DW.
It is, and you're really sitting there second-guessing where everybody's going to go.
Nadeau edges forward.
Wow, that is very impressive considering that nobody has been able to get up there like that since the race started.
And the cars that's pushing him up there, again, is Ward Burton in the 22. And Ron Hornaday, who started 42nd.
Now, everything's going. Bets are off. Got to go back to run a different strategy. Mark Martin, Bill Elliott, Sterling, all of them, they got to rethink what they were doing. What are we going to do now?
Suddenly, the race has changed. What was a single-file procession at the front has Danbury, Connecticut's Jerry Nadeau coming around to lead a lap in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway.
Sorry, Nippy. You'll give in before I do.
Have a bud for my friend?
Yeah, sure.
You ready, guys? This could be the ride of your life. You gotta get past the myths and the excuses. Erectile difficulty is a common problem. Effective treatment is available. Talk to your doctor. You might be surprised how easily you can get through it.
Who makes the best minivan? Obviously, the press has already decided. Dodge Grand Caravan, the best minivan ever. See, compare, drive, Caravan. Now with a $1,500 cash allowance or low 0.9 financing.
I have something to tell you.
What is it?
I'm having an affair.
With who?
Instantly replay live TV.
With your sister, Crystal.
Miss nothing. Ultimate TV. Watch what you can do.
The Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by Budweiser with the crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer. This Bud's for you.
Jerry Nadeau got to lead a couple of laps, and then Mike Skinner came up the outside, bringing Jeff Gordon with him. They lead Nadeau as things continue to change around. And Sterling Marlin, who was leading, has fallen way back.
I think he's going back to find Mr. Jarrett. I tell you, it's like I told you on the opening. I'll stay up there and fight for it as long as I can. Once I'm not in the lead anymore, I'm going to the back.
Now, Sterling slowed to about 174 miles an hour. And, Darrell, you're right. He's right back up to race pace.
Oh, he knows. I think he's just back there. He says, I lost the lead. I'm not going to get caught in the middle of this deal. Going to the back.
Well, he got his 5 points for leading, and now he's going to get back here where there's no trouble, Dick Bergman.
Sterling Marlin's car had been running a little bit loose, and he has been talking to the crew about adjusting it, so he has just dropped to the back. Safety is the better idea right now. Tony Glover keeps telling him, don't worry, we'll adjust it, we'll get it fixed. They'll have pit stops coming up fairly soon, and they will get it fixed.
And Darrell, that's even more of a reason if your car's not handling like you want it to get to the back.
Yeah, well, when you're in front, nobody around you, being a little loose doesn't bother you. You get caught up in the middle of the eye of the storm, and it could spin you out.
And look at that eye on the right side of your screen. You got five cars out in front of it, but then what a log jam.
That's it. You're in the front, you're out of harm's way. You're in the back, you're out of harm's way. But when you're in that wide right there, anything might happen.
Skinner, Jeff Gordon, Dave Blaney, and Jerry Nadeau are out in front of this snarling pack. Those are the getaway cars. And here comes the posse.
The posse is in hot pursuit.
And before the aero package, Darrell, those four cars, they would just keep going away. Now this group back here, they get kind of lined up. They'll be back there in a few laps.
That's as big a lead as I've seen here with this package since they've been running it the last three races.
I guarantee you, cops never had a chase scene like this.
The hounds are on the loose.
Now that's only 0.8 seconds. There's a difference in the speeds between race leader Skinner and Jason
Lynch. Right there, they're starting to pick up some miles per hour. They're trying to get halfway lined up. The more they get lined up, the more cars they get with that pack, the more the miles per hour will climb.
And they're getting away. Now it's 1.5 seconds between packs.
Well, what they realize is these guys back here in this second pack, those guys got away. Line up. Everybody line up. Single file. Let's chase them back down. Won't take but a couple of laps.
And now you see, Leffler is faster than the front pack now that they've gone single file.
All they got to do is just pay attention. Spotter tells them. Everybody works together. Line back up. Chase them back down.
Did this group not get the message, Darrell?
Well, they can't. There's too many of them. Can't get single file when there's that many together.
You need at least two wide to be able to get single file.
Exactly.
Three wide is hard.
Three wide
is impossible.
Four cars out front, then Nemechek leading Leffler, Wallace, and the rest of that six-car group, and then the pack.
Well, we're going to my favorite racetrack, one of my favorite races. I love it, California track, Fontana. Fast speeds, great racing, beautiful facility. Can't wait to get there.
Bobby Hamilton, he's got Ward Burton lined up behind him. Ken Schrader in the 36 car. That's Jeff Purvis in that 51 car. This was the sponsor that was actually going to be on Kenny Wallace's car. Kenny Wallace in the 27 car, they missed the race, moved the Subway sponsorship over to Jeff Purvis.
Oh, yes.
Finch car.
Would you pass me a little gray coupon for my Subway, please?
Oh, gosh.
Now, that would be down in the Hollywood Hotel.
Oh, that's right.
Kenny missed his first race in 5 years. You see the autism ribbon on the side of the James Finch Owens 51. Nice of them to carry that. This being National Autism Awareness Month. Purvis running in 11th place in a car that came here unsponsored, but made the show. Mike Skinner, who last year at Talladega finished second in April and sixth in October, leads here at Talladega. And that four-car breakaway, forget about it. They're all caught back up. And now it's a 10-car draft for the lead. The Talladega 500 presented by Subway.
The action, the heart, the soul of NASCAR every day. Only at NASCAR.com. America Online keyword, NASCAR.
Put the good back into your day. Good Day Philadelphia, only on Fox.
Hey, any luck fixing the car?
I changed the brake pads, but the ABS light's still on.
I'll have Carl look at it tomorrow. You know, he's been doing great at the VW dealer. And he says the high-tech computer diagnostic training he got at ATC made all the difference.
Cars and computers. Carl can do it, so can I.
At Automotive Training Center, you'll get the benefits of an award-winning program taught by master technicians. And best of all, you'll get the training you need for the job you want. Automotive Training Center, the key to your automotive future.
One night at McCool's, a corpse ended up on his floor.
He was gonna kill you.
Really?
A cop turned up in his face.
I'm an accessory in two murders.
A lawyer wound up in his bedroom.
You need some legal advice?
I will give you legal advice.
And the girl of his dreams is becoming a real nightmare.
Well, I gotta admit, she's not perfect.
Do you hate me now?
It's just the sex and the violence. All in one night, it's a little much.
One Night at McCool's, rated R.
Thank you, God!
Starts Friday.
Experience all the action of America's favorite spectator sport at Dover Downs International Speedway. Beginning Friday, June 1st, the tough trucks roar into Dover Downs with the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series MBNA E-Commerce 200. Saturday, June 2nd, the MBNA Platinum 200 Bush Grand National rips up the Monster Mile. Then Sunday, June 3rd, the Winston Cup Series screams into Dover Downs in the MBNA Platinum 400. The hottest cars, the biggest stars, 7,000 new seats, three incredible days, June 1st through 3rd. Get tickets online now at DoverDowns.com or call 1-800-441-RACE.
Welcome back to Talladega. Winston Cup racing on Fox, race 9 of the season at the fastest track on earth. Plenty of room to race here. We've seen them 4 wide, and they've 3 wide routinely as Jeff Gordon has now taken the lead from Mike Skinner.
Well, at least we've seen that outside line work. Somebody can pull themselves up to the lead, and that's what you need here to be able to win this race, actually.
And Darrell, he's sporting those new Pepsi colors, and he made his way to the front without the flame.
I don't see how he did it. Car looks sharp. I like it, but I think it looked good if it had flames on the side.
Steve?
Darrell, Jeff Gordon had been complaining just a few laps ago that 24 car had gotten a bit loose, but he told Robbie Loomis just a second ago after he took the lead that the car handles better on the high side. Let's go to Matt Yoakum.
Steve, we are within 6 or 8 laps of teams making their first round of scheduled pit stops, polling a number of crew chiefs this morning, looking at Saturday's Busch race when Mike McLaughlin, the winner, went 113 laps on his left side tires. A lot of guys thinking about doing 2 tire stops here, only taking about 11 seconds to get the gas in, just take on 2 tires for track position to try to get back up front. But Johnny Benson looking at 4 tires, Todd Parrott, crew chief of Dale Jarrett, also looking at 4 tires as well. Jeff?
Today, before the start of this race, at the drivers' meeting, NASCAR president Mike Helton overemphasized to these drivers, if you notice that line, that yellow line, that today there would be no way in the world if a driver got down below that line unless he was forced down there, they'd be brought in under a black flag for not driving where they're supposed to. They better mind their P's and Q's. We were not going to have a situation like what happened at Daytona. As you can see right now, we've gone over 45 laps. These guys are really doing a great job out there of minding their P's and Q's.
And from 36th to first comes Kenny Schrader. He did not lead the last lap, but he may not lead this one.
Again, he's got a good car there with Blaney right behind him, pushing him right up through there. He gets some good cars lined up on the outside, and I think that's really looking like the fast way. And these guys are probably going to take 4 tires, Mike, because you're going to have to fill the car full of fuel. You got to get all 22 gallon in it, so you've got to put 4 tires. There ain't no need in just sticking a little gas in and going.
I mean, these guys are changing 4 tires in 14 seconds.
Right.
You got to get both cans of fuel in. That takes that long. The track is pretty slick and hot. I want to go ahead and get me my 4 tires, but I'm running up and down pit road to other crew chiefs saying, what do you think about let's change 4? You need to get together. Remember, because of the draft, you don't want to be stuck pitting by yourself.
And the pack really bunches up now. We're going to let you listen to some pure American horsepower and let the pictures tell the story for the next little bit. Take your surround sound at home or in your camper or wherever you're watching and crank it up at Talladega. Ken Schrader gets a big roar from the crowd as he stays out front past the start-finish line and leads a lap. Kevin LePage made his stop. Casey Atwood is among those in on this lap under green.
This is a little bit early. Most of the teams was talking like they could go 50 to 55 laps. Darrell, but it's such a fine line. You want partners on pit road with you, but you don't want half the field.
No.
Heck, it looks like a street in Manhattan at rush hour. You like about 6 or 7, 8 cars with you. If you can work that out, I think that's the best package.
And the thing that I always worry about is when I get ready to pit, be sure that my spotter is telling the other cars I'm coming in, because I don't want to get run over from behind when I start to make my move on the pit lane.
Steve Park, Ricky Craven, and Bill Elliott also pitted that lap. On this lap, Dave Blaney leads a group of about 8 cars onto pit road.
Yeah, wholesale bunch of them coming in now.
Now, you've been out there running 180 miles an hour. You got to get down to 55 miles an hour. We run small brakes on these cars just for rotating weight off the wheels. Sometimes it's hard to judge that speed.
Oh, that in and out here particularly, I mean, makes a huge difference.
Matt Yoakum.
A 4-tire stop for Dave Blaney. No chassis adjustments. Finally, he stalls the car. Blaney stalls the car. Finally pulls away.
Sterling Marlin also pitting during this sequence. Dick Bergeron.
Michael Waltrip with a lousy job of parking here on pit road. Waltrip parked way too close to the wall, and he's just got himself 4 tires and a load of fuel. Sterling Marlin did as well. 2 chassis adjustments on Marlin's car, both of which are designed to tighten it up.
Hornaday, Houston, Mike Wallace, Jason Leffler also pitted. So did Jeff Purvis and John Andretti. Next lap by, and another 10 cars are on pit road. Under green, you cannot pit without losing a lap to the cars that are still out there racing. Steve Burns.
4 tires.
Jeff Gordon's going to come in and get 4 tires. They talked about making a Panhard bar adjustment, and they will do that. They're going to go down one round to tighten him up a little bit. Right side tires going on. Mike Skinner in right behind him. No adjustments to the 31. The 24 now taking on left side tires, getting all that gasoline in. Gordon is down and away. 16.9 seconds. Skinner right behind him.
Things are busy on pit road. More than a dozen cars. Ward Burton comes out. Skinner, Buckshot Jones, Ricky Rudd, Jeff Burton.
And the rest of the field is on pit road.
Yes. Matt Kenseth has taken over the lead, and now Hermie Sadler leads this lap as Kenseth pits. Elliott Sadler the leader. Here's Matt.
Jarrett's already in a chassis adjustment for the 88 car. He said his car was just a little bit loose. 4 tires and fuel for Dale Jarrett. The 6 car, Mark Martin, also in. 2 rounds for the 6 car, and he's down and away. Dale Jarrett now pulls away as well.
And now is when running at the back of the pack can be a little bit of a deficit for you, because you've lost a lot of track position because of where you were when everybody pitted. So he's going to have to go, Dale is, to catch back up at the back of that lead pack.
Elliott Sadler, the leader, will be the last car to pit. Into the Wood Brothers pit stall.
And that's right, 51 laps, which is the longest anybody went. So I'm like Larry, it surprised me that they came out. I thought they'd stay out there a little longer.
But no matter what, you have to make 3 stops. So I guess they decided, let's do it a little early in case we misfigured our fuel mileage. That way we don't take a chance running out of fuel.
And I believe they only took 2 tires on Sadler's car. There's that speed disparity. Wallace, the spotter, telling him, you can come up on track now. Everybody's gone by you that's been running up at speed.
Well, he crosses this line right there. Now he can go wide open. He no longer is at 55 miles an hour, and this pack's coming in the triangle right now. He wants to get up to speed and try to get back with this pack. Here they're coming, running about 3 times as fast as he's running right now. But if he can blend in there, he'll be back with the lead group.
And now the guys at the back of this pack, some of the good cars, they've got to work together to get back up here so that they don't lose this lead draft. There's a good 2 to 3 seconds difference in lap speeds if you lose this draft.
Now, because where the start-finish line is, past the exit of pit road, Elliott Sadler pitted, took 2 tires. He got credit for leading that lap because they're scored at the start-finish line.
But he is not yet up to speed, and the pack should overhaul him before they come back around.
In a hurry.
Bill Elliott goes to the front here in the Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox.
It's about moving forward and not looking back. It's about designing the next generation of lawn tractors that not only cuts your lawn, but cuts it faster. Introducing the John Deere SST lawn tractor with spin steer technology. The only one to come with the technology to spin in place just by turning the wheel. The technology is so advanced, it actually cuts time.
You having fun at your party, honey?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I gotta tell you, son, these last few years have been great.
Oh, they sure have.
But now that you're six, we're gonna have to trade you in.
What if you treated your kids?
No hard feelings, right?
The way you treat your car.
Let's have some cake.
All right.
Don't trade your car in when the warranty's expired. Come to Pep Boys for expert service and now free Gabriel Pro Rider shock installation.
Happy birthday!
All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys.
Guys, switch to Mach 3. Three blades for the closest shave in a single stroke. You'll love the difference. And so will we. Mach 3. From Gillette.
In the battle against athlete's foot, you gotta have, boom, tough actin, Tenactin. Tenactin pump spray is clinically proven to stop the severe itching and burning of athlete's foot. Tenactin is so tough it even prevents athlete's foot. So get, boom, tough actin, Tenactin.
Dirt Wheels magazine ranked it number one. Introducing the Polaris Sportsman 500 HO with 20% more power. And our exclusive independent rear suspension. Right now, when you buy a new Polaris ATV, you get a 2,000-pound Warn winch kit for just $69. Or choose low 3.9% financing. Call 1-800-POLARIS for your nearest dealer.
The Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by Subway, showing the world how great a fresh sandwich can taste. Subway, eat fresh.
That runaway tire you saw out in the tri-oval past pit road belonged to John Andretti. He has had to come in and serve a penalty stop. He's back on track, but he's gone a lap down, the race leader. Bill Elliott last time around, but it's going to be Jeff Gordon with Ricky Craven as they come around through turns 3 and 4. That's how quickly things change here at the world's fastest speedway. Well, what is the latest in a season that the eventual Winston Cup champion had to wait for his first victory of the year in his championship year? That's today's Pep Boys trivia question.
1985.
And who was it?
Drove car number 11.
But now, wait a minute. That's not the question.
Oh.
What's the latest in the season?
I know you went a long time before winning that year.
Yeah, I did.
But I think Terry Labonte went longer than you, and somebody else went further still. Benny Parsons in 73 didn't win until Bristol, the 18th race of the year.
Yeah, I was just a rookie then.
There you are, Darrell. 11th race you won in 85.
Yeah, I was in there somewhere.
Ricky Craven looking for the lead. Jeff Gordon wants to deny him on the outside.
Well, Craven's had a fast car all week. He was one of the fastest cars in happy hour. So him being up there is no big surprise.
Got that Robert Yates horsepower in there again. We mentioned it earlier. Had the problem in half hour yesterday. Back. Fresh motor in this man.
Hornaday and Gordon with a little
bump.
Now look at Hornaday and look at Craven and remember this track's reputation for first-time winners. In fact, I think the first 14 years of the Talladega 500 were run without a repeat winner. Let's recap some of those green flag pit stops, first with Jeannie.
Well, no worries this early on as far as positioning on the track for the 20 car. So yes, indeed, Tony Stewart came in, took four brand new tires, loaded up on fuel. The only concern, the car's a little tight, so they did indeed make a track bar adjustment. A pit stop for Matt Kenseth as well. What can you complain? He started 40th and 7th, took four tires, just air pressure adjustments in all four of those tires, except for the right rear. Matt Yocum?
Mark Martin's crew chief Jimmy Finnick made a call, four tires and two rounds of wedge. The problem, Mark's car was a little bit loose. He wanted to go three rounds, but when he did get out front, they were too afraid the car might tighten up. So just two rounds to Steve Burns.
Well, Matt, Mike Skinner said before that stop on lap 51 that his 31 car was awesome. After the stop, he said, I've got a terrible vibration. Crew chief Royce McGee consulted with all the tire changers. They said, we have gotten all the lug nuts on there. Just try and grit your teeth and get through it. We'll fix it on the next stop, but they don't know exactly what it is. Dick Bergeron?
This morning in the driver's meeting, Michael Waltrip pointed out to everybody that his brother wasn't there to offer sage and sound advice. So Michael offered to do it in his place. And he urged everybody to race in secrecy, to race smart, and wait until the end of the race. And that is what apparently the drivers are doing. For their part, the crew chiefs that we are listening to are telling their drivers, no matter where they are running, be patient. We'll get you a good car if you don't have one. If you got one now, just hang on, because you got a shot to win. Everybody's being patient so far.
...59 laps. Hornaday from 42nd to 1st.
The team has really come around. You know, they led at Martinsville, had a great run up there. Hornaday can get the job done, and I think he's probably a little more comfortable with Fred Graves as his crew chief, although Felipe Lopez, great crew chief, worked for him with him, but this team really is gelling right now.
He is the 10th different driver to lead today as Fred Graves looks on. Former super modified driver and car builder.
Okay, we got another lead change here. Ward Burt, look at Andy Houston in the 96 car going to the high side. They're going to split Ron Hornaday, bringing Buckshot Jones in the 44 and Ricky Rudd in the 28. They're splitting him. We got three wide now with Ward Burt out front.
And you got a three wide pack all the way back. Darrell, if you're in that middle lane right now, have you got a real tight grip?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, this looks nerve-wracking.
You know, you've got cars in front of you, you've got cars beside you. It's the worst place to be. The car doesn't feel good right there. You can drive it, obviously, with it in the middle like that, but it's the most uncomfortable feeling you'll ever have. It feels like it's going to, when you're skiing behind a boat, it feels like you're going to jump over the wake. Did I miss something, or is this a restart?
Look at Mike Wallace in the 7 car. Started dead last. Has not had any kind of a good run since Daytona, where he finished 6th. These guys are back up front here. They was excited about getting back to a super speedway.
Another crew chief change. Jim Long comes on board, and man, I tell you, chemistry is so important. The driver believing in the crew, and the crew believing in the driver. And on a day like today, everybody encouraging each other. I can't say that enough. Please encourage me.
Ward Burton led the last lap. He's the 11th different driver to lead today. We're going to lap past Jeremy Mayfield, who had a difficult pit stop, we're told.
Boy, they closed up on him so fast that they almost run over him.
He was out there running by himself. He's trying to stay with these guys where he maybe could make his lap up should a caution come out.
And that's a tough break for Hornaday because they sandwich Mayfield, and Hornaday stuck.
Yeah, he didn't run over him. He just ran into him.
You're right, Darrell, though. I always said the three C's, communication, confidence, there's no substitute for those things.
No, there isn't. They just mean so much to the whole team. When everybody believes in everybody, when you believe in your pit crew, when you believe in the guy that's working on the car.
Very little differential in speed between Burton and Mayfield, but that inside lane continues to go.
Yeah, I think if I was going to try to win this race, I'd be wanting to get my car where it handled real good right around the bottom.
Oh, 5 wide through the trioval as rookie Kurt Busch in his first ever Talladega appearance got up and almost scraped the wall with that 97 car.
My spirits here tells me you can do 3 wide, 4 wide, 5 wide is disastrous. And you can avoid disaster for a while. But as you run along here and you mentally fatigue, that's what happens. Look how close these guys. It's like working with a bomb maybe that's getting about ready to explode. You're not sure when. And it just wears you out mentally. It doesn't bother you so much physically, but it does mentally. We're coming down into the trial. Well, everybody's moving around, trying to figure out which way to go, what line they're going to run.
Well, Marcus in the 71, he had to do a little dance there.
Cars are really, really difficult to drive right through the trioval.
Okay, I have my breath back now after that.
Well, let's take a break.
Yeah, I think we should. 124 laps to go at Talladega Super Speedway in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox.
You like it fast? Get to your good. Goodyear retailer, where right now, you'll get a $50 fast credit when you buy four selected tires on your Goodyear card account. That's $50 you'll save right on the spot. Qualifying tires include selected Goodyear Eagles, Goodyear Wranglers, and the new AquaTread 3. The $50 fast credit offer, only from Goodyear. For complete details from the retailer nearest you, call 1-800-GOODYEAR.
This is nice, but I thought Stacy said if you bought new tools, she gets a new dining room set.
Yeah, she did.
So where are the table and chairs?
You're standing on them.
Fine woodworking tools from Ridgid. Name proven by pros since 1923. Take our planer with the power and performance to produce superior finishes on stock up to 13 inches wide. Ridgid. Buy them at the Home Depot. First in home improvement.
Who makes the best minivan? In an ordinary minivan, mix groceries with corners, and you've got a recipe for chaos. Or put everything in the all-new Dodge Caravan with nifty grocery bag hangers standard. Even an available fold-away organizer. Dodge Grand Caravan, the best minivan ever. See, compare, drive. Grand Caravan, the minivan rated best by AAA.
The Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox, is brought to you by the makers of the all-new Dodge Caravan. Dodge, different. By John Deere, nothing runs like a deer. And by Goodyear, serious technology, freedom from worry.
And welcome back live to Talladega, Alabama. You're watching NASCAR on Fox. Next Friday, we'll be in California. Wichita kept qualifying on FX, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, as we get ready for Saturday's Busch race at 3:30 Eastern. That's 12:30 Pacific. The Wichita Cup practice you'll see. And then Sunday from Fontana, Napa Auto Parts 500. Sandwiched around Fox Sports Net, NASCAR this morning, and NASCAR victory lane. Jeremy Mayfield, your defending champ at the California Speedway. As we look on the race today, so far, so safe, yet Ward Burton, who was up around the leaders moments ago as Jeff Gordon is now in the lead, had said coming into this race, he's been dreading this race since he left Daytona. He thought NASCAR should have made some changes heading into this weekend. Wasn't sure what they should have been, Jeff Hamlin, but they didn't make the changes. Yet, he said he would approach this race very patiently, and it looks like most of the drivers have done just that.
He has, and they have.
The two wide, two wide.
What is going on is a situation where you go out there and take a chance, what they feel like they're doing here at Talladega. You have to sit down sometimes and talk to your families about why you're doing this. They don't quite understand why a driver gets in that race car. And I think Darrell can probably allude to that, that a lot of times there's a lot more concern with your children, with your wife, even than
the rest of the driver.
Exactly. And they have to, you know, worry about that when they come to a place like this, when you know that a big wreck can occur because of the competition. Look right there. That's a perfect example. There is 20, 30 cars right there in that one huge pack, and if anything goes wrong, it could be disastrous.
Darrell?
Yeah, listen, I tried to explain it to my wife for years, and I think the only thing that she ever thought about was, this is what I chose to do, this is what I was doing when she married me. And I got to tell you, these drivers, contrary to what you may believe, they're very sensitive guys, they all have feelings, and they're all worried. But when you're a macho guy, what are you going to do? Go tell your crew and your crew chief, I'm scared to drive today? So you can't do that. So you suck it up, you set yourself down in that car, and you go out there and say your prayers and hope for the best.
Most of these drivers have family. Many have kids in attendance today. This is what they do for a living, and they have the chance to do something they love. And that's why they're out there. Joe Nemechek has driven his car to the front. Tony Stewart looks underneath Nemechek for the lead.
He's going to see if Jeff Gordon, his buddy, in that 24 car will go with him. I don't think so.
His buddy?
I don't think so. Not today.
Weren't you at Bristol?
I was there.
And you know what? I bet he was motioning to Jeff. Come on, Jeff, follow me, follow me.
Jeff said, be right there, buddy.
Yeah,
right.
I'm here for you.
The only help now that Tony Stewart has is that 12 car, Jeremy Mayfield. He's a lap down. How about Rusty Wallace? Drops to the bottom. Look at Jason Leffler, no one car up there in the third position.
He got some help. Outside only.
That's Ty Bodine right behind the Miller Lite car of Rusty.
Nope, just failed on you.
Yeah.
Outside, just, outside.
Help is on the way, on the way past you.
Yeah, they just bailed on you. That's the worst thing you can hear. You get to working with somebody thinking you got something going, and the next thing you know, they dump you.
It's like, what's that line? Ken Schrader did sandwich. I'm from the government, and I'm here to help you.
Schrader's had, you know, he's gone a lap down, and I don't know what's wrong with his car. I think he had a bad pit stop.
Steve, what happened to Schrader?
We know exactly what happened, Mike. He ran out of gas on pit road, stalled the car out. They sprayed ether in it. He could not get it started. That's why he just lost a lap. Let's go to Dick Bergren.
I'm watching Stacy Compton having a great run today. So is Sterling Marlin. And the same guy built the engine for those two cars has built the engine for the 01 car, which is also having a great run here this afternoon. Tony Santana-Cola, same guy, built the motor for the two cars that started on the front row and for Jason Leffler, who is running up front right now, the 01.
Chasing Joe Nemechek, though, and these are the first Winston Cup laps that Nemechek has led this year.
Wow, I didn't realize that, but Santana-Cola, now that's a great name for an engine builder, isn't it? But I'll tell you, when I would put that cat up against anybody when it comes to restrictor plate racing. He powered John Andretti to a win at Daytona the 4th of July. He worked for Kale for a while. He's a pretty smart cat.
Look at this list, Darrell. These fellas don't know they're rookies. They're running right up front today. They've all had a chance up in the front five.
Five of them in the top 15 right now.
See, their memory don't go back near as far as mine does. So they haven't seen all the harm I've seen here.
How about Dave Marcus up there in the 71 car? His first start of the year, and Marcus has been running in that main pack all day long. He turned 60 years old in March.
And that's somewhat like his teammate Kevin Harvick behind him, because Dave Marcus is in a Richard Childress Racing car, a Richard Childress Racing engine. They left Kevin Harvick's Busch team down here to pit Dave Marcus today.
That's great. One of Marcus's friends from up north, Bob Pulvereri, on the pole for the modified race of Thompson, Connecticut today, 65 years old.
Wow, that's encouraging.
I don't know what they've got, Darrell, but I'm going to want some.
That's very encouraging.
You bet.
I mean, I'm only 54, so maybe I'll lay out and come back and run for rookie of the
year. Look at Marcus. You talk about not being a rookie. He goes to the high side, making it four wide of that 71 car.
Got her up on the outside and wound her up.
He got a run.
Dave Marcus was the last Dodge driver to win at Talladega in the K&K Dodge number 71 in 1976.
Harry Hyde in the K&K Dodge. Yep. What a great operation.
13 different leaders so far. The record is 15 for this race. That last year. Jason Leffler running third, looking for some of Jeff Gordon.
He's got help from Kurt Busch. Kurt Busch dives back behind Jeff Gordon. Sorry, buddy.
Those five cars have broken out to a one-second gap back to the sixth-place car of Buckshot Jones, leading rookie Casey Atwood and Sterling Marlin. We'll be right back.
If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet.
Introducing new extra crispy chicken from KFC. No matter what you hear, it's not just the crunch. It's the flavor in the crunch that makes you munch. We've added extra flavor down to the bone to make it extra tasty. For a short time, get two pieces, two sides, and biscuit for just $2.99. Or 12 pieces for $9.99. New extra crispy chicken from KFC. It's not just the crunch. It's the flavor in the crunch that makes you munch.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Yeah.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Jerry there?
Yeah. How you doing?
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 How you doing? How you doing? So what's going on?
You don't want to know.
When Titus is held hostage, he takes the law into his own hands.
What you gonna do now?
Titus, all new at 8:30 Fox Tuesday.
Welcome back to Talladega, where, surprise of surprises, there's another new leader. Joe Nemechek led last time by. Now Todd Bodine has gone to the front and taken first-time Talladega racer Kurt Busch with him.
Yeah, I said Jimmy Spencer's favorite driver, leading the race right now.
Now, they are teammates on Sunday, Darrell, but
not on
Todd
Saturday.
Wasn't obligated to help Spencer
not on
yesterday.
Saturday.
And didn't. Here comes Kurt Busch. He wants to tie the record for leaders in this race, and does it. Kurt Busch, the 15th driver to lead.
Okay. Interesting names up here in the front, don't we? Busch, Bodine, Hamilton, Atwood.
Mike Wallace, four of those five have never won a Winston Cup race. But this is the kind of track where those things happen. Eight drivers have won their first Winston Cup race here at Talladega.
And, you know, we saw Atwood's car jumping all over the place early in the race, but they did a great job on the pit stop of correcting whatever was wrong with his car. Now he's up there fighting for the lead.
Look at Bobby Hamilton on that 55 car. This is the car that Kenny Wallace finished second in October to Dale Earnhardt. He's wanting the lead here at the start-finish line.
And Casey and Bobby are such good friends. They're both from the same town and around Nashville there.
Rewrite the record book. Bobby Hamilton is the 16th leader of this race. Whoa, and he and Kurt Busch almost get together.
One thing you might notice right here, all four Roush cars up there at the front. You got Kurt Busch, Matt Kenseth, the 99 car of Jeff Burton, and look up there, Mark Martin, and the number six car, Viagra. Roush cars are coming to the front. Undoubtedly, that little trimming of the spoiler has helped this team.
Jeff, you know, they're working together on and off the track as Kurt Busch tries to find his way around here at a comfort level. He actually got some advice from Mark Martin and Jeff Burton. They recommended that he run the top groove. And he was saying that he's not comfortable out there. He had to find a way for himself. But he's certainly been picking both of their brains this weekend to get some information about a track he's never been on, guys.
Well, he's found the fast way around.
And I was with some of the Ford drivers a week or so ago, and I asked some of them, did y'all test the spoiler? And they looked at me like, DW, now you know better than that. You don't have to test something when they give you, take something off of that rear blade.
Boy, the run, Matt Kenseth's getting on the bottom of the racetrack. He's got pushed behind him. He's wanting that lead by the time we get back to the start-finish line. He's got Bobby Hamilton pushing him, and they're three wide behind him going into turn three.
Now, Kenseth led earlier during green flag pit stops.
Sterling was just about to get up there and take the lead back, and then they went three wide on him. Now he's caught in the middle.
40 cars are still on the lead lap. And way back there, about 5.5 seconds off the lead, is our point leader, Dale Jarrett, who also leads our Coke family of drivers. Here's how they are in the point standings. Jarrett coming in here, the leader. Jarrett's strategy all day has been to run toward the back of the pack for quite a ways in this race and see how things shake out.
He's got company back there now. He's got Bobby Labonte and Tony Stewart. Now, we saw these guys do the same thing at Daytona, but I think they made their move a little too quick at Daytona, and they got caught up in that big wreck.
Porter.
20 lead changes so far in this race. 49 last October, the first race with this aerodynamic package, as we ride with the Napa onboard camera of Mike Walter. 14th place.
Back up through there, Michael. Clear all around.
look at this mess coming behind him here. They're three wide. They're four wide.
You know, that looks like something you see on TV.
See, Mike Skinner, the 31 car, led this race after the pit stop. He fell back, complained about a vibration. I got to believe that they balance these tires with wheel weights just like on your passenger car. And when you're turning these tires that much speed, a little bit of weight off of it will definitely make a vibration, Steve Burns.
Larry, I asked Royce McGee, the crew chief, if they had heard any more from Mike about that vibration problem, and he said that he thought, he echoed what you just said, that it was probably just low air pressures right after that pit stop.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of drivers through this whole year complain about vibrations after they make pit stops, and if you get that inner liner and that outer tire, they're not balanced up just right, and the buildup's way off different. It'll take a lap or two for that to go away.
Wow, Mike Skinner just shot around Casey Atwood like Atwood was stopped, and here he goes up alongside Michael Waltrip.
He don't have a lot of help behind him, but he continues to move forward at a fast pace. Look at him just pull away from Michael Waltrip, but now he's starting to sniff that draft of that next pack.
Skinner up to sixth. And now it's his mirror that is full of that pack, and they have caught the leaders. And here comes Skinner. He's not done.
He's getting a little bit of help here now.
It's like Tony Stewart said, pretty good at playing checkers, but never been real good at playing chess. And this is a high-speed chess match.
Fox Track shows you the interval of Mike Skinner from the leader, Matt Kenseth, as he continues to try to pull the outside. He's waving at Jeff Burton behind him to pull up and let's go.
Boy, that car rockets off turn two over there.
And I believe that Dodge is right there behind him. Sterling Marlin's car, very impressive. Works his way right back up to the front.
And you see Skinner cutting that interval to Matt Kenseth.
He's chopped it about 2/10 just since the start-finish line about a half a lap ago. Maintaining the same, about 3.5 tenths. Watch this run right here down the trial. If he gets a little shove here, it'll really close up.
Had to go upstairs a bit the long way around to find some help, and now he tags up with Sterling Marlin. Marlin, though, wants the lead back.
Boy, it's closing now. Get that run right there up off the corner.
Now, see, when they go in the corner, the cars go into what we call yaw. And that outside car is in yaw, and it'll get a lot of air to the rear spoiler, and it'll slow him down, and he gets up on the straightaway. Yeah, it's not Y-A-L-L.
It's not yaw.
Yeah.
Right.
Hard to work that outside unless you get lots of good help. Got to have somebody to stay with you.
Now, Skinner has Dale Earnhardt Jr., but they're three wide as Gordon came right up with Casey Atwood in the middle groove.
Things are starting to tighten up at the ranch, boys.
Go three wide.
The first 30 cars are separated by only 2 seconds.
These guys are starting to talk to their crew chiefs a little bit about that next pit stop. They'll be coming in about 14 laps. I would say it'd be four tires again.
Kenseth, one of 16 drivers to lead this race. Robbie Reiser is crew chief up on the box as plans are being made for that next pit stop in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway.
Shut him up!
The crew faces off with the one man who pushed him over the edge. A shocking boot camp, all new at 9, 8 Central Fox Wednesday.
Pocono. This is the track known for its awesome restarts, incredible high speeds, long straightaways with three demanding turns, and a fan favorite pit paddock pass that puts you near all the action. The stars of NASCAR invade Pocono Raceway twice this year. June 17th, it's the Pocono 500 with a post-race concert by Billy Ray Cyrus. And July 29th, it's the Pennsylvania 500 with a post-race concert by Travis Tritt. So call now, 1-800-RACEWAY. That's 1-800-RACEWAY. Operators standing by.
Looking to forge a brighter future for you and your family? The Caverner Philadelphia Shipyard, the most technologically advanced shipyard in the world, is currently hiring skilled technicians. Now is your chance to become part of a unique team. Work in a clean, safe, state-of-the-art facility where your input is valued.
I'm Ron McAleer, President and CEO of Caverner Philadelphia Shipyards. I personally invite you to join our team as we together shape the future of U.S. commercial shipbuilding.
Who makes the best minivan? At Dodge, we make them great and grand. We make them front-wheel drive and all-wheel drive. We make them with traction control, remote control, even seating, and cargo control. In fact, Dodge Caravan gives you more choices than any other minivan, including the only choice that's under $19,000. See, compare, drive. Dodge Caravan.
Get your fill of The Simpsons weeknights at 6:30 and 7 on Fox.
It only happens once a year. And real NASCAR fans know the truth. Nothing beats being there. This is your chance to experience NASCAR Winston Cup Racing. Live and in person on Sunday, April 29th. The NAPA Auto Parts 500 Weekend at California Speedway. Call 1-800-944-RACE for tickets. 1-800-944-RACE. California Speedway. Live the race.
Matt Kenseth, in only his third Winston Cup start at Talladega, is the leader. He finished 18th and 10th in his two races here last year. And continues to lead Michael Waltrip, Bobby Hamilton, and then any of those cars three abreast behind them.
Hey, Mikey.
He's fourth.
Look at Mikey. He even moved up there in second place.
Three abreast behind them. Hamilton, Craven, and problems for Steve Park, the Rockingham winner. Bit of smoke from behind his car as he drops off the banking.
Comes in here fifth in points. This could really hurt where he's at in the point situation.
Yeah, that's definitely engine failure, so I'm sure he'll be going to the garage. Hey, Mikey, going to the front.
First time today for Waltrip. I think it'll be our 17th.
You're clear there. Clear all around.
We have set a record for this race, but in July of 1986,
pick your lane, 26. Clear all around.
Now, this is what Dale Earnhardt was always so good at. You see where Michael's setting? This is where I watched Dale, and he would just kind of work backs and forth, backs and forth. And then he would jump into whichever line looked like he had the most head of steam.
Steve, what happened to Steve Park?
Mike, we understand he has a flat tire. He was not going to stop until about lap 99. It's a flat left front tire. So they're going to take this opportunity to come in and do their service. They're going to take a 1 pound out of the right rear, put a round of wedge back in. But a flat left tire for Steve Park.
Yeah, I could see that smoke coming out of the left front, and I thought maybe it was an engine problem. It's good to know it's a tire, and then get that fixed and get going again.
When you have a flat in turn one, it's a long way to pit road.
And it's a wonder it didn't tear up something. That tire come apart and start whooping the oil cooler out from underneath there.
How about this rookie right here, Casey Atwood? He's got the help of the other Dodgers, Sterling Marlin. I believe I'd have stayed up there, Casey.
Yeah. Well, what'd you do that for? Should have stayed out there and let him push you across the line, bud.
They had a head of steam. How about Sterling Marlin? Led this race early. Car got a little bit loose, went all the way back to the back. After the pit stop, he's worked his way, and he's back leading two laps before halfway.
Setting up for pit stops at Talladega, so we'll take one. We'll be back with more NASCAR on Fox.
There's something big happening at Subway. Two new gourmet breads. Delicious Asiago cheese with real Asiago cheese baked on top and tasty country wheat with rolled oats, poppy seeds, and more. Subway's two new fresh baked gourmet breads. They're causing quite a stir.
Hey! Nice pajamas!
Subway. Be fresh.
Thank you.
all you want, but nothing can replace the rush you get from a Kawasaki Ninja.
3 minutes from now, a heart attack victim will be rushed into this emergency room. Medication will be injected. IV fluids will be needed. The patient will be protected from infection. Breathing will be assisted. And one more life will be saved.
Samson?
Yes?
Hi, I'm Dr. Moore.
Oh, her husband's doing fine.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Thanks to advanced medical techniques and a material we call plastic.
Grandstands and infields. Pistons and thunder. Muscles and speed. Men and machines. Speed waves and octane. Scanners and pit stops. Checkered flags and championships. Trophies and beer. Start your engines, baby. I'm a race fan.
The Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox, is brought to you by MBNA, issuer of the official NASCAR credit card. Log on, MBNA.com.
For one of the first times today, we have two packs of cars in the Talladega 500. Sterling Marlin leads Casey Atwood and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Mike Wallace and Kurt Busch. Still 39 cars on the lead lap. And back through 30th place, it is one pack of cars. Then a gap to some veterans. Jimmy Spencer, Bill Elliott, Dale Jarrett, Johnny Benson, Bobby Labonte, and Tony Stewart.
Kind of interesting. You know, you think back to Daytona, never saw Michael or Dale Jr. near the front until real near the end of the day. And here they both are. Michael led, and Dale Jr.'s right up there fighting for the lead.
Now again, as in the first sequence, Kevin LePage will be the first car to drop off pit road and pit, and Earnhardt Jr. leads, and the crowd comes to its feet. First time today that Dale Jr. has led a lap.
Well, they love that.
You gotta love that.
A potential win in Texas, foiled by a late pit stop. Earnhardt Jr. puts the Bud Chevy out front. Took Casey Atwood along to second place.
Casey got a run on Sterling right here. Sterling gives him the inside, but then he tries to take it away. Casey had to go down about half of a lane below the yellow line. Being a rookie, I'm not so sure that NASCAR wouldn't want to talk to him about that.
And they will, Darrell.
The black flag. That means go to the pits and find out what you did wrong.
And they'll probably take their time telling you.
His teammate, Bill Elliott, becomes one of the first to pit under green. Second pit stop of the day.
Well, it's time for pit stops. You know, we're up to lap 97. Everybody will have to make this stop and one more. Darrell, I'm going to give you four tires. Then you're probably going to finish the race on these left sides. I'm going to give you two later on.
I like that. Go ahead. I'm with you. I'm singing the same song, buddy.
Only thing bad about Bill here, a lot of trouble right here on the left side. The only problem is he's in there by himself. He's got some sort of, they're holding him. He must have been speeding on pit road. See, he was speeding on pit road, so they held him for 15 seconds, and he's definitely going to go a lap plus more down. Steve Burns.
There you guys are talking about inner liners, tires within a tire. This is the left front off Steve Park's car. This was a cut. They've already circled it. You can see my pen sticking through there. But the inner liner did its job, and it stayed fully inflated, allowing Steve Park to make it back down to pit road.
Boy, what a safety item Goodyear come up with there. That's just a tire within a tire. If it had not been for that, we could have had our first caution.
Casey Atwood is in, making their pit stop repairs now. He will serve an additional 15 seconds. Too fast entering the pit, we're told.
Boy, when it goes bad, it just all goes bad, doesn't it, Larry?
Yeah, 55 miles an hour, and again, I guess it's so hard. You got your tack to go by, but so hard to judge at after being out there for 50-something laps running 180-something miles an hour.
And being a rookie, this is like discipline. They got to call you in and talk to you, you know?
And we're being told he was out of fuel to add to it, and when your motor's not running, your tack's not working, you don't know how fast
that's
you're running.
That's why he was speeding coming down pit road. Happens a lot.
How about Kurt Busch, that 97 car of Jack Roush? First time ever at Talladega. and he's had no reluctance to put that car in the wind out front.
He runs so good at Daytona back in February, though.
Oh, yeah, he was right up there amongst them.
Jeff Purvis and the James Finch 51.
Now, this team finished second yesterday. The team did, Finch's team, in the Busch race, and having a pretty darn good run today.
And this is a Ford, and they run Ernie Elliott motors that Ernie built last year before converting over to building Dodge motors.
Earnhardt Jr. down to the inside and slicing off for Pitt Road.
Michael Waltrip with him. Mike Wallace, Sterling Marlin, Jeff Burton, Bobby Hamilton Jr. Pitt Road fixed to get busy for the next four or five laps.
Yeah, Michael actually got down the past Dale Jr. before they got to the line, which is legal. Dale Jr. slowed down a little too quick.
And Ricky Craven leads this lap. He is the, I believe he's the 19th different leader of this race.
Dale Jr.'s got a good pit. He's in the second pit down here at the end, so he's going to be able to get in and out real easy.
Dick?
The instructions to Sterling Marlin were to make sure he got wide around the 15 car so they didn't get tangled up coming into the pits. This was arranged that the 15 car of Waltrip and Marlin would fit together. To Steve Burns.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. getting left side tires. They have some changes on their crew. Jeff Clark will gas instead of Jack. Four tires, no adjustment for Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Whoa, we about had a wreck at the exit of pit road. We had four cars trying to go for that hole at once.
Now once they pass that line, they can accelerate full speed.
Our leader, Ricky Craven, in the 32, he's hit pit road as well now. He's bringing about 9 or 10 cars with him.
Ward Burton, Kurt Busch come in. Dave Blaney is in. And Mark Martin is the leader. Jeannie?
Well, no adjustments on Ward Burton's car this time around, guys. It was loose. They made an adjustment at the last pit stop, but he is feeling great with the vehicle. Just looking for four tires and some fuel to get back out on the track.
Kevin Harvick is in for four tires and fuel as well. A very experienced pit crew here working on this car. These guys have all worked together for a long, long time, and they are among the very best in the business. Jack Mann, Mike Moore flying around the front of the car. They've already got the rights on, lefts are done. 15.9 seconds, a nice stop for Harvick.
Green flag stops continue. There's Mike Skinner finishing up. Mark Martin goes to the lead. He and Sterling Marlin have now led every race this year, the only two drivers to do so, as Martin pits with Johnny Benson, Matt Kenseth, Dave Marcus, and John Andretti. Jeannie?
Well, Matt Kenseth was complaining the car was a little tight, so they're going to take a turn out of the left rear, and of course, he wants four tires. He doesn't want to risk it out there. He's going to take the time to get all four tires on and the fuel as well.
That engine sounded a little rough.
It's up against the rev limiter. They put a rev limiter in there to keep him from over-revving it, and that's why it was chattering like that.
Benson, who's way down pit road, finishing up, and here's Stacy Compton. Dick?
Well, Stacy Compton's problems are not going to be fixed on this pit stop. They believe that they've either got a broken shock mount or a broken shock altogether. That's why this long, long stop to try and get it squared away. Crew Chief Chad Knaus has just waved his hand, told them behind the wall. The pole sitter, big problems on the right front. Going to go behind the wall and try to fix him. To Matt Yoakum.
On the previous stop, no adjustments for Ricky Rudd. This stop, the same call. No adjustments for the 28 car of Ricky Rudd as Ray Holm goes to work on the rear. Bobby Burrell in the front. Cleans off the windshield. Norman Cochabizo gets that can, packs that fuel cell full of fuel, 16 seconds, and he pulls away, as does the 20 to 26 of Jimmy Spencer and the 88 of Dale Jarrett.
Rusty Wallace had taken the lead, but now also comes to pit road, completes his service, and heads out.
These pit stops are so, so critical. If you don't have a good pit stop, you lose that lead draft, buddy, you're out of it.
Now, instead of going behind the wall, it sent Stacy Compton back in the race.
Well, yesterday in the Busch race, Nemechek broke a shock mount. I think that's what put him out of the race. And these shocks are so aggressive, as Larry will tell you, they got so much rebound, they're so strong, that they'll just rip themselves right out of the tubing they're welded to.
Yeah, I mean, I think teams do a great job of putting the shock mounts on, but again, the shocks, as you say, Dale, they're just so aggressive. Just pound, 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 pound. It just rips the mounts right out of the frame.
Rusty Wallace with Robert Presley running 1-2 as they come back up to speed. And a little bump drafting going on there as they get back to full speed.
There's Mark Martin right there in the picture and Ricky Rudd, and here they all come.
Todd Bodine with him. Ricky Rudd, that's six Fords in front of Dale Earnhardt Jr. there in that pack with a Chevy. And look, Sterling Marlin's Dodge.
Look at Todd Bodine, that 66 down to the inside. But Rusty pulls him here, headed off into turn one, three wide behind him.
Todd Bodine, we're told, is going.
All right, you're doing good. Pay attention to that yellow line. It's ready to post at 66. He just dips down there trying to go by you. They ain't going to put up with that bullshit today. He's coming in for a stop and go. These cars coming hard on your inside.
I loudly applaud what they are doing today. It is ridiculous to run these cars down on these aprons. That's what causes trouble here. They've been warned. You got to show these guys sometimes.
Did he dive down there or was he... Did he run out of room?
Yeah, he dove in.
Down there.
That was
no different than what Atwood did. Same thing.
And the reason all this area is asphalted is because in the past when there was grass down there, these cars would slide down there. That would start these cars to tumbling and rolling. They put the asphalt down there for safety, but it's not to race on.
I'm glad. I've said for years, boys, we need out of bounds. I know that there are boundaries, but we need out of bounds, and now we are finally getting around to making that obvious.
This is the second pack led by Kurt Busch, the fifth-place car, battling Rusty Wallace. Bobby Hamilton, the 55, Jeff Burton's 99, and Jeff Gordon's 24. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is your leader. Again, Todd Bodine is being black flagged for that move below the yellow line. Sterling Marlin will become the second-place car, then Mark Martin. And then that pack led by Kurt Busch. 105 laps have been completed here in the Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox.
You're not taking that with you, are you?
Watch this.
Wow.
Excuse me? Do you have the time?
Conseco, NASCAR's official financial services provider.
Come on, boy. Let's make this quick. Whoa! It's got to be the dog chow.
Purina Dog Chow delivers 100% nutrition, including important antioxidants to help support a strong immune system. Dog Chow, the nutrition he needs to keep on amazing you year after year. Incredible dog food, incredible dog. Purina Dog Chow brand.
Four identical cars. Four identical engines. Only one running on New Havoline, our latest triumph in Havoline motor oil technology. And what difference does that make? Not only do you get unsurpassed performance, but tests show that with New Havoline under the hood, you get better gas mileage. Havoline. Add more life to your car.
Buy 12 quarts of Havoline motor oil and get this die-cast collectible for just $5.99 while they last.
Talladega 500 presented by Subway is brought to you by New Havoline motor oil technology, formulated for improved gas mileage. Add more life to your car. By the joy of Pepsi. And by Viagra. Ask your doctor if Viagra is right for you.
Fox welcomes you back to Talladega, Alabama. We're looking in live on the Talladega 500. Dale Earnhardt Jr., your leader. Talk about walking on eggshells. How about driving on eggshells? Only one other time have we gone through the entire race here and not had a caution. That was in 1997. No caution so far. 19 different leaders. That's a new course record here. More than 20 lead changes. And Dale Earnhardt Jr., whose father had won more races here, the great late Dale Earnhardt, 10 than any other driver. And look at the speed record, Jeff Hammond, here is Mark Martin, who, of course, led through some of the laps today. NASCAR's all-time record. We're talking about tremendous speeds, but at a tremendous safe pace.
Exactly right, Chris. And to emphasize that, if you notice, NASCAR made a statement, as I said earlier, if you make a mistake and go below that yellow line, you're going to come in and we're going to let you think about it for a stop-and-go penalty. So far, two guys have made a mistake.
I believe the rest of the crew chiefs and spotters are saying, look, NASCAR is not giving you no second chance, guys. Keep it on the track, on the playing field. As Darrell said, don't get it out of bounds. So far, we had a really nice race.
And Dodge with the front row, of course. The last Dodge to win at Talladega was Dave Marcus, who was running in his first race of this year at age 60. He won in 1976, went in a Dodge, and we'll keep an eye on him in this race. Let's get out to Steve Burns. Steve?
Thanks, Chris. On the most recent round of green flag pit stops, Jeff Gordon came in. They took on four tires, went down another turn on the track bar. Meanwhile, Mike Skinner, they had problems. Three lug nuts fell off the right rear tire, or off the wheel rather. They had to go back, tighten them up, and send Mike back out. So he lost viable positions here off pit road. Let's go to Dick Berggren.
Joe Nemechek's air conditioning system has just quit, and he has said it is hot as swell downstairs in that car, and they're very unhappy with it, but not as unhappy as the pole sitter, Stacy Compton. They did pull the right front shock off the car on that long pit stop. They didn't put another right front shock on it because the mount is broken, and that car is just porpoising out there. He's having a tough time. Jeannie.
Well, Dick, we're worrying about trouble on the track. How about on pit road? Matt Kenseth, rear tire carrier, Brian Dunaway, actually caught his foot on the hose as he was coming over the wall. Now, fortunately, Matt had already pulled the car into the pit stop, and he was able to get up and finish his duty. Just a twisted left ankle. As you can see, he's back to work. Matt?
We told you earlier about Mark Martin's loose condition. They did make a chassis adjustment on the previous stop. No adjustments on his last stop. He was very happy with his race car. His teammate, rookie Kurt Busch, a problem-free pit stop. No adjustments, just four tires and fuels. Guys.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. leads this train around Talladega. Rusty Wallace, who, if memory serves me, has never won a restrictor plate race.
Finished third at Daytona back in February.
Yep.
Junior was second. Michael was first. Michael's falling back a little bit. Kind of funny how the guys that seem to be really good at Daytona are ending up back at the front here at Talladega.
Bobby Hamilton third. Mark Martin fourth. Bobby Labonte, the Winston Cup champ, has fought his way up into the top five. Jeff Gordon sixth. Robert Presley, Buckshot Jones, Jeff Purvis, and Dave Blaney are the top 10. And Larry, what's happened to tail end Charlie?
Well, I've been sitting here studying a little bit. We got 112 laps on the board. I think it's time to change the schedule, DW. He has moved up to 17th. The time has come to go.
Yeah, I think it's a little early. He did that at Daytona. Him and Bobby Labonte and some of them that were riding in the back, they made a move to go with about 40 laps. I believe I'd have waited just a little bit longer.
He's got his teammate right in front of him there, Ricky Rudd, in the 28 car, though. They got that inside line trying to move.
Well, what happens to you is your crew chief and your team is also, man, Keith, why don't you get up there and lead a while? Safer in the front. So the problem he's got to go by all these guys because he was in the back. Maybe he and Ricky can get up there and get the lead together.
Next week, Darrell, we go to another big speedway, but a very different speedway than Talladega out in California.
Yeah, it's a little flatter. It's a 2-mile racetrack. It's a beautiful facility. I love going there. It's one of my favorite tracks. Speeds will be high there, probably over 200 miles an hour down the straightaway without any problem. Should be some great racing.
There's definitely some teams have tested out there that has shown straightaway speeds of over 200 miles an hour.
Riding with Jeff Gordon as Robert Presley and Buckshot Jones go past.
Boy, I'm proud of the 44 car, Buckshot Jones. Look at Jeff Purvis hitting the 51. He wants to go by him there, but Buckshot Jones, these guys not had a good season at all. Best finish of 19th at Atlanta. Come here, qualified 29th. He has four DNFs this year, so this could get the season turned around.
Darrell, some of those abrupt moves, is Jeff Purvis making you a little nervous?
Well, Purvis makes you nervous, yeah. You don't need to be doing that, but it's kind of like Larry said. I think right now you're starting to hear from your crew and your spotter saying, okay, bud, we need to get ourselves in position here now. Let's don't give up any more spots. Let's start taking places, and when that happens, you can get a little impatient. Guys are getting tired, mentally tired right now. Cars are moving around a little bit. Got to be careful.
What they got to do also, they got to start setting themselves up for that last pit stop here, probably in about 35 or 40 laps, probably two tires to get them to the end.
Boy, things change. We started with three Dodges in the front three spots, and now the only Dodge in the top 10 is Jason Leffler. It's a Chevy up front, then Rusty Wallace, Bobby Hamilton, Mark Martin, and Robert Presley. That Chevy is this one that you're riding on board. The Bud Chevrolet of Dale Earnhardt Jr. 115 laps complete at Talladega.
You having fun at your party, honey?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I gotta tell you, son, these last few years have been great.
Oh, they sure have.
But now that you're six, we're gonna have to trade you in.
What if you treated your kids?
No hard feelings, right?
The way you treat your car.
Let's have some cake.
All right.
Don't trade your car in when the warranty's expired. Come to Pep Boys for expert service and now free Gabriel Pro Rider shock installation. All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys.
Play the millionaire game at McDonald's. There's cash on every car.
That's easy, man. It's Mobile.
Yeah. More money.
Jefferson. Gotta be Jefferson.
Love those presidents.
Yeah. Cash, baby.
You have a chance to win $1 to $1 million. There's a cash prize on every card. Can you find it?
You order more fries?
More chances for cash. How many states begin with the letter W?
The millionaire game at McDonald's.
Bling, bling.
We love to see you smile.
The most powerful Duracell Ultra ever. With the advanced performance of M3 technology, it's the most powerful alkaline battery in the world.
The world's best stock car drivers want you to come to their 4th of July party, the Pepsi 400 at Daytona International Speedway.
The 88 team loves Daytona, and we want to win there again in July.
We won the Pepsi 400 last July, and we're going to have a blast this year, too.
Super Speedway racing is better than ever, and I can't wait for the Pepsi 400.
For tickets, visit our website or call 904-253-RACE. The Pepsi 400, Saturday night, July 7th. Don't miss this party.
Beyond the Glory looks back at the life of one of NASCAR's greatest legends, Dale Earnhardt. Beyond the Glory, tonight at 8 on Fox Sports Net.
He's locked that thing out of there. They're going to need tires. You see how it takes leaps forward?
I'm time to win. I'm time to win.
Right from the green flag.
Tie time here in Talladega. Now, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Darrell, has been pulling these lead cars around the outside of the racetrack and leaving the bottom open. And look who's there, Marlin, Jarrett, and Rudd.
Well, you know, we've seen guys go up on the outside, get the lead, and then immediately fall the inside. And I think what Junior's doing is kind of the best of both worlds. He's running the outside a little while, then he'll move out. He's coming off a little high there. He's got Rusty right with him. That's what you got to be able to do, though. You got to play this game. Where's everybody going? That's where you want to go.
Does the car run freer, higher up?
Oh, yes. Yeah, you're not turning the steering wheel near as hard to the left. You're not binding it up, as we like to say. It'll run faster if you can get it up there and keep it wound up.
Clear. Dale Earnhardt, all-time winner at Talladega with 10 Winston Cup victories. Buddy Baker, Bobby Allison, and Darrell Walter, four apiece. Earnhardt Jr. looking for his first win of the season.
The whole key to success here is a fast car. I mean, every time that you come here and you got a fast car, you think this place is easy.
Boy, talking about two fast cars. Look at Sterling Marlin in that 40. Dale Jarrett in that 88 working that bottom side.
Well, you heard Todd Barrett say that it took them about 10 laps to go from the back to the front. I think they're testing that theory right now.
Boy, it don't look like 33 degree of banking from this angle.
No,
it's like
doesn't.
The side of a building when you stand at the bottom of it. Yeah.
Looks fairly flat. Doesn't look like 190 miles an hour either. That's the thing that's so deceiving. This place is so big, so wide, and fairly easy to drive that it's very deceiving how fast you're going, how high those banks are, how difficult this really is.
From first to 29th, just 2.2 seconds separate that group.
And we're 121 laps into this race, well over halfway.
Unreal. And thus far, caution free.
And you wonder how.
Yes.
when they're all that close together in a pack like they are,
and you wonder how they cannot have something happen.
Now, there's the first pack. As we mentioned, 29 cars were in that first pack. And then that group comes all single file.
But let me tell you, that group was way, way, way. I thought they were out of the picture. I've been watching them, and they are closing up at about a second, and about almost a second a lap.
But that's a good pack of cars. Almost all of those cars have led today. You got Jerry Nadeau, you got Mike Skinner here in the 31 car. Look at Ron Hornaday in the 14 car was up front earlier. This is a good pack of race cars.
Larry, there's as many cars have led today as haven't. Half the field has led this race.
Wow, that says a lot about the competition of NASCAR Winston Cup racing.
And there's Todd Parrott, or Todd Bodine right back there in that 66 car, who led earlier, but made the mental error of going below the yellow line, and now he's a lap down.
Like Jeremy Mayfield as well in the 12 car.
And Casey Atwood's up in that crowd somewhere, did the same thing.
This pack right here, I think the spotters have gotten together and they said, look, guys, we're not doing anything. About the time I say that, Mike Skinner pulls out of line, but you guys are not gaining if you're going to run side by side.
Well, he can pull out of line now because they've about caught him.
There's that second pack, and there is the interval to the leader, Jerry Nadeau, and you see that number growing a little smaller as they run single file.
They're there now. And that's pretty amazing because, I tell you, I watched those guys. I said, boy, there's some really good cars that are out of the race. And lo and behold, they're right back up there.
And all of that's because of that aero package. Those cars up there dirtying up there, poking a big hole in there, let them run right back to them.
Got a big old boat making a wake in the water.
And now it's a 42-car draft once again. The only car out of the race, pole sitter Stacy Compton with that broken shock absorber mount has taken his car to the garage. Dick Bergeron?
Oh, Stacy Compton behind the wall, and it's more than the broken shock mount. They're working on the motor, working on the fuel vent back here. What's going on, Stacy?
Well, I'll tell you what, when it rains and pours, I hate it for the guys with Kodiak, Mellon, Dodge. Got a good car all day. You know, we figured out what we could do at the beginning. We led a few laps and decided to do like a lot of other guys, go to the back and ride around. And, you know, when we needed to go, we could go. And we broke a shot there right before that pit stop. I was hoping for a caution. Come in, I sit in the pits, and with it idling, I'm not sure whether we burned a piston or may have broke a valve spring. I'm not sure what, but we got more problems than just shocks right now.
What's the traffic like out there today?
I mean, the guys are pretty much using their head right now. A lot of guys riding around in the back waiting for that last 50 laps, and I think his last 50 laps is going to be pretty interesting.
Yeah, we think so, too.
This lap was pretty interesting because they were four wide at the flag stand.
Being very careful not to get below that yellow line.
Yes. You won't see a rush hour like this anywhere. Thank goodness. Dale Earnhardt Jr. hauls them around the Talladega Super Speedway in the Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox.
If your house could talk, what would it say?
I'm the house I am because of the tools he uses. Look at him. He even looks like a pro.
The tools you buy at Lowe's are the ones the professionals use. Names like DeWalt, Milwaukee, and Porter Cable. Because Lowe's understands the value of the right tool for the right job.
No wonder I'm the best looking house on the block.
Lowe's, improving home improvement.
Here's something your car can actually use. The Fram X2 oil filter uses revolutionary triad fiber technology to trap up to 70% more dirt than any leading filter, giving you 7,000 miles of peak performance. It's just something you gotta have.
You started saving for your kids' college education before they were born. Your wife still thinks of you as her knight in shining armor. And the neighbors know your door is always open. So it comes as no surprise that you choose auto parts that meet the highest standards in the industry. AC Delco. When the right way is the only way. Visit a location that features AC Delco automotive parts.
Hey,
there's something big happening at Subway. Two new gourmet breads, delicious Asiago cheese with real Asiago cheese baked on top, and tasty country wheat with rolled oats, poppy seeds, and more. Subway's two new fresh-baked gourmet breads. They're causing quite a stir.
Hey! Nice pajamas!
Subway. Be fresh.
The Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by Subway, showing the world how great a fresh sandwich can taste. Subway. Eat fresh.
Fox welcomes you back to Talladega Speedway. According to legend, Talladega stands on an old Native American burial ground. And 1 year, Bobby Isaac in 1974 leading the race, but pulled over and walked away after he said he heard voices in his head that told him to get out. Right now, Dale Earnhardt Jr. is your leader. Chevy has won the last four races here at Talladega. And we had a terrific Busch race yesterday that rearranged the points. Kevin Harvick was your leader, but Jeff Hammond, Greg Biffle is now.
Greg Biffle, last year's truck champion, in front of that Roush Racing Ford of his. And then also Jeff Green is posed back up, last year's defending.
You mentioned the truck series, the Sears Craftsman Truck Series results after four of 24 races. The point standing, Scott Riggs leading Joe Ruttman.
Joe Ruttman, the Wiley veteran, driving Bobby Hamilton, and young Ricky Hendrick, Rick Hendrick's son, driving his first Craftsman Truck Series this year, running third.
All right, it's worth pointing out we've had a Talladega record here in our Winston Cup race. 21 different leaders so far, 27 lead changes.
Still single file, four back.
So far, absolutely no mishaps, no caution flags. That has happened once before in the history of this race.
One thing I'd like to add here, watching this race today reminds me kind of like putting a bucket of water on the top of a stove. You turn on the burner, and slowly but surely, she starts to boil. This is the way I think this race is heading. She's getting ready to get hot and very, very testy.
And when Dale Earnhardt Jr. took over with 92 laps to go, the fans here, there was a roar of applause. They were up and cheering him on. Let's check out Steve Burns. Steve?
Well, guys, they're talking about strategy, when they're going to come. If it stays green, they'll need just one more pit stop. Crew chief on the 55, Jimmy Ellis, down talking to Tony Urey, the crew chief for Dale Earnhardt Jr. They've made an agreement. They want to come between laps 149 and 152. And in fact, it's a handshake agreement. So it looks like a done deal.
More deals being made. Teammates up and down pit road.
Tony, you're just telling me, take a number. I'll get to you when I can. But this is the thing. Most places we go, if you can outwit somebody by changing two tires versus changing four, it's an advantage. Here, if you don't get people on sync together, pitting at the same time, doing the same work on the race car, you're going to end up in trouble. You'll be by yourself.
Well, I kind of agree. And think about this, Larry. I mean, think about Dale Earnhardt. He came out way back last year. I don't know. But with this aero package coming out a little behind, ain't a bad thing, really.
We've seen that all day.
I think I'd get my four tires.
Darrell, one thing starting to worry me is we just saw Buckshot Jones go into that corner and almost slide up into Kurt Busch. Drivers are going into the corner in the middle lane and are sliding way up the racetrack.
Well,
I don't so much mind them running four wide, but when they don't hold their lane, I'm starting to get nervous.
Yeah, well, that's tire wear, track conditions. You know, the track gets slicker as these cars run, and the cars will change quite a bit.
57 laps to go. Caution free thus far. At least one pit stop to go. And it's getting awful racy here in Talladega. We'll be right back.
Get inside the live racing action with RaceCast. Any driver, every lap. Only at NASCAR.com. America Online keyword, NASCAR.
It's about anatomy.
She had man hands.
Seinfeld, weeknights at 7:30.
Rock, rock, rock. It's NASCAR days at Roth Rock Chevrolet. And we're driving for number one. Get checkered flag savings on new Monte Carlo SS from $19,495. New Blazers from $19,995. New Suburbans from $28,995. New Tahoes from $29,395. It's NASCAR days. And we're driving for number one at Roth Rock Chevrolet. Roth Rock, rock.
92.5 XTU, Philadelphia's country station.
This is country.
Man, I feel like a woman. Baby, I love you.
This is country. This is Philadelphia country.
92.5 XTU, home of Harmon and Evans.
In
Try them tomorrow morning, 92.5 XTU.
Experience all the action of America's favorite spectator sport at Dover Downs International Speedway. Beginning Friday, June 1st, the Tough Trucks roar into Dover Downs with the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series MBNA E-Commerce 200. Saturday, June 2nd, the MBNA Platinum 200 Busch Grand National rips up the Monster Mile. Then Sunday, June 3rd, the Winston Cup Series screams into Dover Downs in the MBNA Platinum 400. The hottest cars, the biggest cars, 7,000 new seats, three incredible days, June 1st through 3rd. Get tickets online now at DoverDowns.com or call 1-800-441-RACE.
New leader, Sterling Marlin. A lap ago, Dale Earnhardt Jr. came into the trial with the lead, and as we were saying, he slid a bit, slid up high, and paid the price.
Oh, yeah, he went from the lead just one lap ago back to about 10th or 15th just that quickly. That's what I say, things happen so fast here.
There he is in 13th place, paddling side by side with Jeff Burton.
Fighting for 13th.
Yeah, trying to hold it.
And comfortably leading just before the pass.
Now they're working their way up the outside alongside Robert Presley and Bobby Hamilton.
Whoa, man. There.
The three wide. The three.
On board the subway cam with Jeff Purvis. And once again, let's give you a chance to enjoy all this horsepower and all this speed and fury of Talladega. The pictures will tell a story while you crank it up. For Jeff Gordon up on the high side. That's not the lane that's moving.
Right now it's like it's you don't want to be late for quitting time. 5 o'clock's a coming. Everybody's picking up the pace. Tempers are starting to flare. I tell you, a lot of times I believe the reason wrecks happened in the second half of the race, mental fatigue. You just can't keep your focus that long for 3.5 hours.
Darrell, I'm glad you brought that up. That was exactly what I was wanting to ask you a minute ago, was in 1997, you ran this race here without a caution. What's the mental state of the driver right now? You've been out there, you've been battling for 138 laps side by side, working back to front, making pit stops. Where are you at right now as a driver?
Well, you mentally are being drained because you're having to make so many decisions. This is like a computer. It's like a computer sitting there having to make so many decisions every time you ask it a question. Feedback to the crew, racing people, somebody running into you. You lose your temper. You're hot. Your arm weary. You've been fighting that steering wheel for 2 hours. Buddy, I tell you, right now is when you've got to suck it up and be the man.
And there's things in the race car you can't do that you do in a road car. If you're going to change to the right lane in a road car, you do a head check. You look over your right shoulder. You can't do that in the race car.
Most of these guys, the way they got their seats built today with these big headrests and all, they really can't see. They have no peripheral vision. So they're just making moves on instincts mostly.
You talk about that, and looking at the cars in the garage area this week, I kind of liken the seat configuration a lot of these drivers have got to blinders on mules. Honestly, they cannot see without the help of their mirror or their spotter.
Well, right now is when you got to sell that mule. Don't worry about the mule going blind. Just load the wagon and hold the line.
Boy, this is a great shot. This gives you a great view of what these race cars are doing.
Let's go to pit road and Jeannie.
Well, guys, 10 to 15 left. That's how long the 88 crew still thinks it's going to take Dale Jarrett to go from worst to first. What we've seen him is, we've been speculating, of course, he is experimenting here, trying to test that theory to see exactly how many it will be. Most important, they're admitting in the 88 pit, hey, they haven't even begun to show their hand. The shark is circling. Dick?
Joe Nemechek's air conditioner problem has been repaired. It wasn't the air conditioner at all. The hose had fallen off his helmet, so he wasn't getting cool air. Joe fixed that himself. What he cannot fix is it appears as if he has a shock absorber going bad. Same problem Stacy Compton had. The car is bouncing all over the racetrack. Nemechek having a hard time hanging on to number 33.
Compton is back on the racetrack after making repairs. In 43rd place, and Johnny Benson has picked up a hitchhiker on his hood fin.
That could very well be a tear-off off someone's windshield.
I believe it's a white flag. I think it's a white flag. He's waving a white flag. I give up. I surrender.
Subway sandwich wrapper.
Oh, that may be what it is. Yeah, there's a lot of those floating around today.
We had a lot of cars just on pit road, mainly cars that was lapped down. I think Steve Park, Bill Elliott, some of these guys getting in, getting their pit stop done.
Yeah, they're getting in early, trying to be out of sync so that if a caution should fall, maybe they'll be able to catch it just right.
Marlin the leader, Rudd in second, Hamilton, Waltrip, Mark Martin, Andy Houston, the rookie up to sixth, and two rookies right behind him, Kurt Busch and Ron Hornaday.
One groove, clear low, one groove.
Jeff
right on back. Come on.
And rookie
on.
Kevin Harvick
out
of the top 10. 47 laps and at least one pit stop to go. It's been green flag racing all the way so far at Talladega.
She just doesn't understand me.
What's to understand? I mean, what is that, Michael?
Is that what you think I sound like?
Mr. Doyle, do you use a cellular phone? What's come between you two is static. Here, Sprint PCS built the only all-digital, all-PCS nationwide network, so your calls are clear.
Thank you.
Sprint PCS, plans starting at $19.99, including real nationwide long distance.
You like it fast? Get to Goodyear, where right now you'll get a $50 fast credit when you buy four selected tires on your Goodyear card account. That's $50 coming your way. For complete details from the retailer nearest you, call 1-800-GOODYEAR.
Introducing new Armor All Protectant Wipes. Armor All Shine and Protection, now in a wipe.
From the quarter mile at St. Louis to the third turn at Talladega to the pits of Laguna Seca, wherever innovation is the margin between win and lose, the pros reach for the same tools you do. Craftsman, the official tools of CART, NHRA, and NASCAR.
The Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by UPS, the official delivery company of NASCAR. We want to race the truck. People love the truck.
Welcome back to Talladega. Next week, the NASCAR Busch Series goes to Montana, California. We'll have Winston Cup qualifying there Friday on FX. It'll be on the air at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Then on Saturday, Winston Cup practice on FX at 2:30 Eastern, followed by the NASCAR Busch Series on Fox at 3:30. On Sunday, NASCAR This Morning on the net, the Napa Auto Parts 500 here on Fox at 2 p.m. Eastern, the NASCAR Victory Lane.
Go west, young man. There's gold in them air heels.
Will we have a new leader as Mark Martin tries to eke his way out front?
That was partly caused by the slow car of LePage coming out of the pits, and they all had to move around him, and that gave Mark a better line around the outside.
And how about who's pushed him? Ron Hornaday in the 14 car. It wasn't but about 15 laps ago. He was in that pack that was behind the lead pack. Here he is pushing Mark to the front of the pack.
Let me tell you who's fallen way to the back is Jeff Gordon has fallen out of
sight.
Back to 29th. You know, the driver leading the most laps here at Talladega has only won two of the last nine races. Sterling's led the most laps today.
I'd hate to, other than just having a sentimental favorite like I did in the beginning, Dale Jr., I'd hate to pick a winner in this deal.
You could pick 10 cars and not be sure of a winner. Nick Bergeron.
Sterling Marlin may have an overheating problem. The temperature gauge is at 240 degrees, which engine builder Tony Santanicola told both me and his crew as well, who has told Sterling, don't worry, it'll run at 240 all day long. Trying to tell Sterling Marlin not to worry when the temperature gauge is at 240 probably isn't going to work. They are worried, even if Santanicola is not. He's the engine builder.
Well, it's a distraction. It's another one of those things right now that you do not need. You don't need to be worried about the temperature gauge, because what you first think of as a driver is, all right, I got to get some clean air. I got to get somewhere where I can cool this engine off. And there is no clean air. So how are you going to do that?
But you know what? We do have to decide, Darrell, and I'm going to talk to my crew chief buddy down there, Jeff Hammond. We're going to have about 38 laps to go. One reason I'm wanting to put two tires on you is that I can get enough dancing partner. We've talked about how long it takes these guys to dump two full cans of fuel in. We only need one can and just a little bit of a second can. Jeff, you thinking the same way I am?
I'm awful torn right now, Larry, watching these guys slide around here. But if I've got a crew like Robert Yates, I may go ahead and try to get me four tires, because they can just about put what's necessary in that car, and the car seems to be good enough to make its way back up there. There's going to be a lot of decision-making going on. If I've got a crew that can put four on, I'm going to get me four. If I've got a crew that I'm a little guessing about, I'm going to get two. That's the sure thing, because like you're saying, you cannot afford to lose the draft this late in the race. You never get back up through there.
Listen, guys, I got to do the hardest driving I've done all day. I'm going to have to make moves that I haven't made all day long. Don't hang me out with two tires. Give me the grip. Give me the control so I can go where I got to go, make the moves I got to make. Even if it means losing a spot or two, I can get back up there if my car is handling good.
But I got to believe we're probably going to see a combination of situations. Probably going to see teams change four. Probably going to see teams change two tires.
But, Larry, I've seen the crew weigh those gas cans after the last stop. And if you come in with 38 laps to go, can you do that adding just one can of fuel?
No, you're going to have to get a little bit of that second can. You're going to have to get a little bit of that second can. Not a lot, but they are going to have to plug it in and get some out of that second can.
Hey. Bobby Hamilton just got bumped right there. That was close, and you see him lose a little momentum, and a car scoots around the outside.
And consider this, Larry, one other thing, and I know we're up here and we can talk about this for a long time.
Whoa, boy, these guys are starting to feed on each other.
The more rear weight you got, the faster your car's going to be. The more fuel you pack in there and lower that back end down, the faster your car's going to be, too.
Gets that spoiler out of there.
Yes, sir.
Up front, Marlin looking under Martin for the lead, and no room there. Here comes Ward Burton around the outside.
And Darrell, I hate to say this, but I agree with you this time when you talk about that fuel situation. Getting that spoiler out of the air may allow you to come down that back straightaway and make a run for the lead, whereas if you don't get it completely full, you got a little more drag put in the car. With this new aero package, it really makes a lot of difference who your dance partner is more than anything else.
Bring it all around, bud.
Yeah, there's just so many things to consider. I mean, and that's part of it.
Ricky Rudd just took the elevator from the top lane all the way downstairs and into the lead.
And that's the first time he's led today, isn't it? I think it's the first time he's been out front all day.
Correct.
And pit road's getting busy. Next three or four laps, we got about 12 cars on pit road.
Rudd is the 22nd leader of the race as Michael Waltrip and Mike Skinner are among those pitting. Bobby Hamilton's in. Dick Bergeron.
Michael Waltrip surprisingly pits by himself rather than pitting with the 40 car with whom he has pitted all day long. It's probably going to be a four-tire change. He has pitted far enough out for that. Yes, indeed, it will be a four-tire change for Michael Waltrip. Winner of the Daytona 500, runs so well here all day long. This is the best shot he's had since Daytona to win a race. Waltrip now gone. 21-3 to Michael Waltrip. overall trip, not a good pit stop. A bunch of new guys on his crew today.
Mike Wallace, Ron Hornaday, Kevin Harvick pitted with him. So did Buckshot Jones and Dave Marcus. Joe Nemechek, John Andretti also in with that group.
The next group is on pit road, about another dozen cars. But this is good. This don't put no 20 or 25 cars on pit road at one time.
No, I think that's the right thing to do. You know, break them up to where you got a chance to get into your pit.
Dick?
Sterling Marlin pitted really well now. He's got the car exactly on the blocks where he needs to be. Tony Santanicola, we were talking about him all day. The engine builder just pulled the last piece of plastic off the windshield. That's the last time Sterling's going to have an absolutely whistle-clean windshield until this race is over. There he goes. Christine Burns, 16.86, emerging.
Dick, four tires for the 24 of Jeff Gordon. Slight chassis adjustment to the left rear. He's down and away, 14.5 seconds.
I believe Gordon's car must have been getting loose if he put some wedge in that left rear.
Riding with Ricky Rudd, Mark Martin just behind him from the Haviland camera as they come to pit road. Robert
One,
Presley
four
taking
tires,
over the
Ricky.
Lead.
Four tires. Get it full, Norman.
Talking to Norman, Coach Muse of the Gas Man. Matt?
And the six car, Mark Martin is in a four-tire stop. Sean Parker putting on the rear tire. They were talking about two, but they were too worried about getting out in front of everybody and have everybody reeling them in. The 28's down and away. Ricky Rudd's gone as the tied ride of the 32 and Rusty Wallace, four tires and down and away as well.
Ricky Craven and Johnny Benson also on pit road in this sequence. And Robert Presley, who was the leader, peels off for pit road. And with him is Dale Jarrett. Labonte leads this lap. Jarrett's in. Genie.
Well, guys, last minute adjustment for the 88, just like the 28. They came to the wall with two tires, but everybody else took four, so what the heck? Why don't you put four on? Put fuel in there as well. Complete fill up. And Dale Jarrett's going to be on his way. Maybe the pit stop going a little slower than they would have liked.
16.2 for Dale Jarrett. He'll grab second gear.
Good job.
And drive the speed limit down pit road. And Bobby Labonte, the Winston Cup champ, has picked up the lead. His teammate Tony Stewart is the second place car.
He's coming to
Labonte
pit road.
Pits.
He's coming to pit road. Going to bring his teammate Tony Stewart in a 20 car with him as well.
I think their strategy is pretty obvious. Come in together, lead together, work together, see where we can get to before this thing ends.
Jimmy Spencer also in.
Cleaning that windshield. Got to have a clear view for these last few laps.
Windshield gets so sandblasted here at these high speeds.
Stewart away in 17 seconds. Labonte pitted much further down pit road. So it took him a lot longer to get into his pit stall.
Stops going well. It's going to be a pretty quick one.
Oh, he stalled.
Oh.
Quick stop.
It happens so often.
And Matt Kenseth comes out with Stewart, then Labonte, then Spencer.
You kill the engine so often. Once they got real high gear in the car, but you've been riding with that left foot, not doing anything with it. So you come in, you're holding the clutch in, and your leg just kind of maybe a little bit asleep. So it doesn't always pop. You pop the clutch, kill the motor.
Because Tony Stewart won the war off pit road, he got credit for leading that lap. He's going to lose it here, though. Brett Bodine in the 11 car, he's actually the leader of the race right now. But he has not pitted.
And look, here's Tony way down here. And look where Bobby is, way back here. That's the difference in their pit stops.
And Tony Stewart looks like Grandpa, the old guy in the hat in the fast lane. Come on, I got to get past you here. I'm faster than you. Until you get up to speed, at least.
He wants to try to get up there amongst them. Maybe they'll get him going quicker.
25 different leaders in this race. That's more than half the field.
And look who's in third place. Look who's in first place, actually. You know, Burton had a pretty good run at Martinsville and is leading the race today. So they that team's definitely on the right track.
Jeff Burton has now tied the all-time Talladega record for number of leaders in one race at 26. We'll be right back for the Talladega 500 presented by Subway.
Introducing new extra crispy chicken from KFC. No matter what you hear, it's not just the crunch. It's the flavor in the crunch that makes you munch. We've added extra flavor down to the bone to make it extra tasty. For a short time, get two pieces, two sides, and biscuit for just $2.99 or 12 pieces for $9.99. New extra crispy chicken from KFC. It's not just the crunch. It's the flavor in the crunch that makes you munch.
Store your favorite shows digitally, so you can watch them whenever you want. Ultimate TV. Watch what you can do.
Hey, Dad, what's that?
That's a pink flamingo.
What's that?
Bullfrog.
What's that?
That, son, is a Chevy Monte Carlo.
If you want to see 700 horses under a hood, spend a day by the lake on the famous Daytona infield, but bring your Visa card, because you won't get in with American Express.
Isn't nature great?
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
You having fun at your party, honey?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I gotta tell you, son, these last few years have been great.
Oh, they sure have.
But now that you're six, we're gonna have to trade you in.
What if you treated your kids?
No hard feelings, right?
The way you treat your car.
Let's have some cake.
All right.
Don't trade your car in when the warranty's expired. Come to Pep Boys for expert service and now free Gabriel Pro Rider shock installation.
Happy birthday!
All you need to know is where to go. Pep Boys.
Get ready for the season's final five episodes, leading to the most shocking moment of all. The X-Files, all new, starting at 9, 8 Central tonight on Fox.
Fox welcomes you back to the Talladega 500 presented by Subway. Let's have a look at the Pepsi race summary here as we have gone through 157 laps. A Winston Cup record has been tied for number of leaders at 26. Lead changes were 34, and it's been all green. No cautions one other time at Talladega since 1997 was the only other time that they had a race, Jeff Hammond, when they did not have a caution. It's not like we're disappointed. We're just amazed that we've had such great speeds. And how about the strategy? Our points leader and Dale Jarrett going for his third straight win. Currently second. He sat back for a while. He waited. Now it looks like he's poised and ready to make another move with 30 to go.
Strategy and confidence. That team right now, it's on a roll. They made the right pit selection, pitting all the way up toward turn four, came in under a green flag stop, got in and out, came out second. They're right now in the catbird seat early on in the race, and they dropped all the way to the back. They're trying to protect themselves a little bit. These guys are taking a look at the big picture. They realize there's a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, and they're trying to get there.
All right, it is Jeff Gordon said about Dale Jarrett. He's having a Tiger Woods type of year. Let's get on to Jeannie Zelasco.
Yeah, sitting in the catbird seat and also sitting in the best pit, by the way. We should point out the 88 crew, they have the only shaded pit stop on this entire track. So they've been keeping cool and comfortable. Also trying to keep comfortable would be the teammates, 28, Ricky Rudd. It's possible he had a disappointing second place finish at Martinsville. He's losing to Dale Jarrett.
Jeannie, with Bobby Hamilton pitted in the 55 car, he said he felt like he had a flat tire. He came down pit road. The crew looked at it, couldn't find anything wrong with the tires once they took them off, but they did find some body damage. Mike Joy, I believe, mentioned that the 55 had been bumped. They did find body damage on that left rear. Let's go to Dick Berggren.
Well, if this race stays green, the crews have done all they can for the drivers. About all they can do right now is to cheer him on, wish him well, tell him what line to be in, because no more adjustments will be made if this thing stays green. To Matt.
And I just spoke with Greg Zipidelli, Tony Stewart's crew chief. A flawless stop by the 20 crew, but the problem they have is the left front fender has been caved in about halfway. Tony made contact with another car. He never said on the radio which car it was, but the problem, his car cannot suck up on the cars in front. He can't pull out and make that pass. Right now, he's just going to have to ride.
Warwick Burton has had to serve a penalty stop for pitting out of the box, so he has gone one lap down. Kevin LePage has taken the Morgan McClure Chevy to the garage. And Darrell, this whole race has changed
complexion since the pit stop.
Oh, yeah. Well, like these guys keep saying, all bets are off. Right now, you put your game face on. Whatever you can do now, you do it. You don't leave any, you don't take any prisoners now. Just flat out, belly to the ground, right to the finish. Sterling Marlin just displayed that little move when Dale Jarrett tried to make a run on him going down into turn one, ran him up to the top, and then dropped to the bottom and picked back up a lead draft. Right now, Dale Jarrett's back in 15th place. You're not going to give anybody anything now. Want anything from me, buddy, you're going to have to take it.
Now this again, this is when all the deals are off. There'll be 25 laps to go next time. You have no buddies. I used to preach that to Mike Skinner. Race after race here in Daytona. You're on your own agenda. You do what you have to do to win this race.
This pack is now 29 cars strong. Michael Waltrip's about 10 seconds behind them. Don't know if he'll be able to run them down or not.
He don't have a whole lot of help to catch back up to this pack with those few laps.
No, Michael's done for. Unless there's a caution, he's out of it. Two guys can't do it.
How about Johnny Benson in this 10 car? He was back there with Dale Jarrett. Now he's up to third position here with 25 laps to
and
go.
And like Dale Jarrett, yeah, he was in provisional land all day, Larry. We never saw Johnny Benson except on pit stop.
And Dale Jarrett in three laps has gone from second place to 25th. I think he was making his run. He was happy where he was, but Sterling kind of put an end to that.
Well, inquiring minds want to know, is that to plan?
To fall back now?
Yep.
No, not now. He was right where he wanted to be.
He was making his move for the lead, and it didn't work out.
No, it didn't. He tried to pass Sterling, and Sterling took him to the top, left him hanging.
But once he lost the lead pack, is it get out of town time again, or is it too late for that?
This is the problem that he run into. Now he's back in the middle of the field. Now he can't go all the way to the rear and start over again. So he's got to try to go from where he is.
And the intensity of the eye of the storm will grow here.
Yeah, you can hear it coming.
Storm clouds brewing in Talladega, and we don't mean skyward. Things are closing up for the lead here in the Talladega 500, presented by Subway on Fox.
Easy boy.
You like it fast? Get to your Goodyear retailer, where right now you'll get a $50 fast credit when you buy four selected tires on your Goodyear card account. That's $50 you'll save right on the spot. Qualifying tires include selected Goodyear Eagles, Goodyear Wranglers, and the new Aqua Tread 3. The $50 fast credit offer, only from Goodyear. For complete details from the retailer nearest you, call 1-800-GOODYEAR.
I'll tell you what, on race day, you better get it right.
You want a hands-on boss.
Yeah.
He is.
Terry Labonte.
Terry Labonte.
Check the transmission and the drive shaft.
He's involved in every detail.
Right.
Absolutely.
Hey, if that makes me a perfectionist,
one more pound.
So what?
There's a fingerprint on the windshield.
Got it. Hey, I'm here to win. Blue.
The nose needs to be bluer.
Blue's very good.
Yeah,
blue.
Very,
blue's great.
Very good.
Dirt Wheels magazine ranked it number one. Introducing the Polaris Sportsman 500 HO with 20% more power and our exclusive independent rear suspension. Right now, when you buy a new Polaris ATV, you get a 2,000-pound worn winch kit for just $69. Or choose low 3.9% financing. Call 1-800-POLARIS for your nearest dealer.
When one of her own goes on a rampage, Max must confront a secret from her past.
Why are you doing this?
No, why? Dark Angel, all new at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
In the Talladega 500, Tony Stewart is the leader. Kurt Busch, the rookie, is second. Johnny Benson is third. Well, that makes Well, now it's two. It was four of the first seven. Now it's two of the first six, looking for their first ever Winston Cup win. And this is the track for it. This race has seen eight first-time race winners, including the first Talladega 500 winner, Richard Brickhouse. The owner of that winning car, Ray Nichols, has been under the weather. We want to say hello to him. But also Donnie Allison, Ron Bouchard, Dick Brooks, Bobby Hillen, Phil Parsons, Lenny Pond, and Kenny Schrader got their first wins here.
We got 20 laps to go, and 20 laps here at Talladega, it is a long, long time.
I tell you what, the fingernails, mine are down to the quick. I don't know about y'all, but I can't go much further.
Let's find out about strategy. Let's go to the leader's pit and Jeannie.
Well, the first strategy we have to deal with Greg Zipidelli is the fact that this fender is dinked. How do you think it's going to affect you? How's the car running?
Right now, it's not affecting it too bad. We made a change this morning to, if we could get in the lead, it would be better. And it seems like it's paying off for us right now. It doesn't want to suck up as good when it's behind. We had a little bit of a hassle getting up there, but right now it's doing all right. We'll keep our fingers crossed. There's a whole lot of racing to go.
All right, to Matt Yocum.
And Todd Parrott is the crew chief for Dale Jarrett. Your driver's been fluctuating from 15th to 20th. We're within the 20 lap to go window. When does your guy need to make a move?
He told me last night that he knew what he had to do. He saw what the man did here last October. And getting down toward the end, and he seems to be making a pretty good little move right now. So, I don't know, maybe the man's talked to him.
He's trying for his sixth plate win. Now let's go to Dick.
Chip Ganassi has a reputation as a brilliant IndyCar strategist, but if he wins today, it'd be his first point win ever in Winston Cup. His driver, Sterling Marlin's got a shot at it. What's your strategy from here, Chip?
Well, you know, on the last stop, everybody was thinking about two or four tires or whatever. Seemed everybody went with four, so that's the end of strategy. Now it's just about track position from here on out.
All right, that's up to Sterling Marlin.
Todd Parrott was talking about the man. The man is Dale Earnhardt, who had 10 wins at this racetrack. Earnhardt lost his life on the last lap of the Daytona 500 while trying to hold third place in a pack of cars as tightly knotted as this one.
And you see Dale Jarrett down on the inside there kind of buffing in and out on and off of Buckshot Jones. But Dale's starting to try to work his way back up to where he was before he got run up the track by Sterling Marlin.
Boy, Mike Skinner in the 31 was getting a good push from Ricky Craven on the 32 car, but as they went off into turn one, it's like it pushed him up the racetrack.
Let's have a look at the damage to Tony Stewart's car and how it got that way.
Back corner.
Woo!
Got into the back of Johnny Benson earlier in the race.
He sideswiped him. Slideswiped him.
That's that little dink in the left front fender Jeannie spoke of.
Doesn't seem to be hurting anything.
We're going to put a lap on Jeff Purvis.
Might have narrowed the nose up a little bit. Make it run better.
Kurt Busch shoving Stewart down the straightaway toward turn one.
Got to be pretty impressed with Kurt Busch.
I'd say.
Been up there all day. Got that Sharpie out. He's ready to make an autograph in Victory Circle.
There's a lot of bump drafting going on. Moments ago, Ricky Craven and Mike Skinner.
Just staying on it, bump draft, bump. But this was going off into turn one, and then this is where Ricky, I think, slid way up the racetrack after they got into turn one.
That's friendly. Those are friendly bumps. Just nice little casual bump. Picks up the speed of both cars. Just wanted to only be sure you do that on the straightaway. Don't try that in a turn.
Jarrett on the inside has now pulled himself up to ninth place. We'll be back to Talladega on Fox after this.
My heroes don't catch touchdowns. They don't slam dunk. They don't hit home runs. They don't score goals. They don't give smackdowns. My heroes burn rubber. They fight steel. They bleed octane. They risk their life in every turn, on every track, in every race. My heroes race cars. Fast cars. Trucks. Fundamentally tougher than any panty-waist car. Hey, no one ever wrote a song about his first hatchback. At Craftsman, we figured the only thing better than trucks is
is racing trucks. So we're the official tools of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Tough trucks, tougher drivers, and the toughest tools, Craftsman.
Introducing new Armor-All Protectant Wipes. Armor-All Shine and Protection, now in a wipe.
In the battle against athlete's foot, you gotta have, boom, Tough Actin Tenactin. Tenactin Pump Spray is clinically proven to stop the severe itching and burning of athlete's foot. Tenactin is so tough, it even prevents athlete's foot. So get, boom, Tough Actin Tenactin.
Hey, guys. This CD-RX DI is running great. How about a splash of gas, and I'm out of here.
Have you got any kings? Go fish.
Hey, are you still mad because we didn't let you drive? Come on, Jimmy, it's my turn to drive.
Oh,
I
see
you drive. Right on the back, right on the back. My turn to drive.
That's where you belong, on the back.
I want to drive the boat.
The Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by AC Delco Automotive Parts, when the right way is the only way. By Ultimate TV from Microsoft. And by Miller Lite. Grab a Miller Lite. It's Miller time.
Getting down to crunch time at Talladega. Crank it up on Fox. Well, we'll just have to do that in this segment. But right now, Tony Stewart leads him across. Kurt Busch, Johnny Benson, Mark Martin, Jeff Burton, Ricky Rudd, the Wallace brothers, Mike and Rusty, Jarrett and Kenseth are the top 10.
Well, for 175 laps at Talladega, this has been the greatest job of driving by these drivers that I've ever seen here. They've been very, very courteous to each other today.
Below the yellow line and then pop back up there into Joe Nemechek, but he didn't drive down there. He had to go down there. That was a defensive move.
Yeah, I believe that what I was talking about, that courtesy and all, you know, when that started, it started in the driver's meeting this morning. When these guys were told they were going to be black flagged if they didn't do certain things today, they heeded that.
Two wide outside.
And that courtesy may all go out the window with 10 laps to go. We'll be back for the final 10 laps of the Talladega 500 after this.
Hey, let's show more road. We're gonna get some Asiago cheese.
Scusi?
All right then, next stop, Scusi. Chop, chop, presto.
Subway introduces two new fresh-baked gourmet breads. Delicious Asiago cheese with real Asiago cheese baked on top. And tasty country wheat with rolled oats, poppy seeds, and more. Two new gourmet breads at Subway.
Stroke!
Subway. Eat fresh.
Would you please get out of the kitchen?
There's no better feeling than that of a job well done. And nothing helps you do the job better than America's number one filter, Fram. There's no better feeling than that of a job well done. And Nothing helps you do the job better than America's number one filter, Fram.
Who makes the best minivan? Dodge Caravan has the only power rear hatch with cargo organizer. Check. The only movable center console. Check. The most powerful engine available. Check. The only three-zone automatic temperature control. Check. Dodge Grand Caravan. The best minivan ever. Check it out. See. Compare. Drive. Grand Caravan. The minivan rated best by AAA.
You're not taking that with you, are you? Watch this. Wow.
Excuse me? Do you have the time?
Talladega 500 presented by Subway on Fox is brought to you by the Joy of Pepsi.
180, caution, three laps. Only eight laps to go. Tony Stewart leads rookie Kurt Busch in his first Talladega appearance. And Johnny Benson, who's also looking for his first Winston Cup win. And it'll be seven to go when they come back.
And I believe Stewart watched that Busch race yesterday. You see how he keeps dropping that car right to the inside, particularly off turn four, not letting anybody get a run on him.
Steve Burns.
We've been listening to crew chief James Entz talk to Johnny Benson in that 10 car. Johnny said, I can make a move. I can go past those guys whenever I want. James said, absolutely not. You stay where you are, you tighten your belts, and you wait till that last lap and stay on the bottom. Let's go to Dick Berger.
Kurt Busch in car number 97 is doing an incredible job. This kid is just 22 years old, making his first ever start at Talladega. He didn't test here. He didn't practice here. All his experience has come this weekend. He's used to running well at new racetracks, however. When he first started at Daytona last year in a truck, in his first start, he finished second.
The car that won yesterday's race has the same number as Tony Stewart, comes from the same team, and was driven by Greg Zipidelli's former driver in the NASCAR Modified Series, Mike McLaughlin. So there was a lot of sharing, Darrell, between yesterday's winning car and Tony Stewart's team about how to win on this track this weekend.
By all means, and we heard Mike McLaughlin say over and over again, couldn't give up the bottom. And you watch Tony Stewart, he'll jerk it right down to the inside off of the corner, not letting anybody get a run on him.
You got Bobby Hamilton in that 55 car. That's his teammate, Joe Nemechek, in the 33. That's the two cars that pushed Dale Earnhardt to the victory here in October. And Dale Earnhardt Jr. in that 8 car is behind them.
Sterling Marlin, who led in the early going, is way back in 16th. Jarrett is back in 13th. More than half the field has led this race. But who will win it?
Five laps to go this time.
They don't know what to do now. They can't make any, they're kind of bottlenecked up. The traffic can't go in the high line, can't go in the low line. Just going to have to wait and see if anything shakes out in front of them.
And they'll be waving their arms. But Darrell, this many cars in the pack, you can't work with nobody. You got to get out of hope when it's there.
No, this is just hoping for an opportunity. You want to be an opportunist right now. If something comes to you, take it.
Why do they build all these seats here? Nobody's sitting in them.
Just for numbers. Seat numbers.
Kurt Busch, he is not coming off the rear bumper of Tony Stewart in that 20 car. He has been locked to it for about five laps.
Darrell, if Tony can stay right along that yellow line, can he be beaten?
I don't think so. Yesterday, I stood here and watched in awe as the 20 car, Mike McLaughlin, held him off at the very end. He was down on the apron even. But let me tell you, it's going to be hard to get by that 20 car today.
Todd Bodine has gone to the garage, only the third car out of this race, joining Kevin LePage and Stacy Compton.
But here comes that outside line. Here comes that 55 car on the outside, teammates, and they're making some inroads into the lead. They got Dale Jr. with them.
On pace to be the third fastest Winston Cup race ever. And caution free, 3.5 laps to go.
It's pushing and shoving now. You take everything you can get. If there's room, you take it. If you're in the room, you take it anyway. This is as intense as it gets, folks. Let me tell you, right now, those drivers' hearts are pounding out of their chest.
Harvick makes it three wide back about 15th place and gets together with Bobby Labonte.
And you've been leading the race. You've been up front. You know you got a car capable of doing that, but you can't get there.
You know, one thing I believe that's keeping that outside line from going, Darrell, they're running too close to the inside line. That's stalling that outside line out, and they can't get that momentum.
Bobby Hamilton's out there trying.
So, Larry, you're saying Hamilton needs more air between himself and those inside cars?
A little bit of an air gap.
But if he did, Larry, think about this. If he moves out very much, there'll be three wide.
I said a little bit. Not a lot. Just a little bit.
Last year, Tony Stewart won more races than any Winston Cup driver. This year, so far, he's been snakebit. 28 of these cars are on the lead lap, and there's probably 28 of them that could win this race, even with just two to go.
Outside line run here, getting a little bit of line. There you see Dale Earnhardt Jr. Come on, come on, Randy, come on.
Here we go. He's there. He's going to get up alongside of Tony Stewart going in the corner.
Your line's still moving, again. Bud. Do a nice job right there.
Place on back.
Boy, it's going to get really, really wild if they get side by side for the lead.
And once the white flag comes out, all bets are off.
We'll see that next time by. 1.5 laps to go.
Can Stewart win his first of the season? Can Kurt Busch or Johnny Benson win their first race ever?
Well, we saw Jimmy Spencer yesterday get along beside the leader, but he couldn't get by him.
Tony Stewart seeing exactly what he wants to see. These cars side by side behind him as they come to the white flag.
Got to do it, man. Got to work both sides of the street.
Oh, he almost got Hamilton as he came up the racetrack.
That damn hurt Tony's momentum.
It hurt his momentum.
It did, and Hamilton gets the lead.
That's his teammate again behind him on the white flag lap.
And he doesn't want to leave his teammate hanging, but he's got to, or he may lose the lead to the 20 car.
I'm sure he needs to get to the bottom, and he goes to the bottom in front of Tony Stewart.
That leaves his teammate, Joe Nemechek, out to drive.
Now Bobby Hamilton's got worry.
Hamilton comes up to take Nemechek along.
Play both sides, Bobby, both sides.
Oh, he's got to go to the bottom, Darrell. Protect the bottom.
Protect the bottom.
Mark Martin, you don't want to have to make it three wide.
Folks, just remember, the start-finish line, when you come off of turn four, the race is just beginning.
Hamilton, Stewart, and then three wide behind them.
If he'll protect the bottom, I don't believe they can beat him. He goes to the bottom here off turn four.
Nice block.
Time to pop it, baby.
Five wide behind him for the last time through. And they are four abreast for third. I believe Kurt Busch got it.
And I wouldn't even begin to guess from fourth back.
I never saw anything like that in my life. I mean, I saw Bobby Hamilton win, but I never saw that many cars come across the line that close together.
And Darrell, everyone's prayers today were answered. We have a safe race at
Tony. Oh, thank God. Thank God we had a great day and a great race.
That was awesome.
And Bobby Hamilton, my buddy.
Kenny Wallace second last October for this team. And Bobby Hamilton, when Wallace left, Hamilton replaced him at Andy Petrie Racing and scores his first Talladega win in his 19th start.
Look at this back here. For Pete's sake, how are we ever going to figure out who runs 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th?
Look at that.
Look at that.
Wow.
That's a score nightmare right there.
Now, somebody's going to have to tell their sponsor tomorrow. How'd you do? Well, I finished half a second behind the winner. Well, where were you? 12th. Steve Burns.
All right, crew chief Jimmy Allegracini, congratulations.
Jimmy.
From Richard Childress. Jimmy, tell us about that victory. That was a wild one.
That's unreal. I'll tell you what, Bobby did a super job there. You know, we kind of messed up on that last pit stop there, and it wasn't real good. And, just put four tires on him, and that's what worked last year for us with Kenny Wallace. And you know, Kenny followed Dale to the front with that same car, and you know, this was for my old buddy Dale. You know, we sure missed him, and all the people at home, the Earnhardt families, they're watching us. It's for y'all.
Let's go back upstairs to Mike Joy.
Thanks, Steve. An emotion shared by many here as they check the spoiler on Hamilton and send him to victory lane.
Jimmy Ellich, for a number of years, worked on that black three car and was a tire changer.
And a very, very intelligent guy. Great, great crew chief.
It's the fourth career victory for Bobby Hamilton. Chevy congratulates Bobby and the number 55 Monte Carlo on the big win today. Here's the Chevrolet winning moment. The pass on Tony Stewart. for the lead. Puts Bobby Hamilton in Talladega victory lane. We'll be right there in a moment.
If you've got a big job, Labor Ready is the nation's leader in temporary labor and the first to offer a 100% satisfaction guarantee. If you aren't completely satisfied with the work, call us within 2 hours and we'll take care of it, no questions. Just call 1-800-24-LABOR. You can find good help these days. Labor Ready. Dependable temporary labor.
When you retire, Conseco offers a wide variety of retirement products that can help. Conseco, step up.
Just $1 a day. Falling in love with a Yamaha V-Star has never been easier.
Welcome back to Talladega, where a safe, caution-free race has given Bobby Hamilton his fourth career victory. He's in the MBNA winner's circle. Hamilton led just 3 laps today and gives car owner Andy Petrie his first Winston Cup triumph.
He'll be able to up the limit on his MBNA credit card now.
My microphone is soaking wet. You led just 3 laps. How did you win this thing leading so little?
I'm too damn tired to talk to you.
Catch your breath. Everybody in victory lane is in tears. The crew chief, Jimmy Ellich, is in tears. And Andy Petrie, the owner, first win, is in tears. How'd you do it?
Watched that 3 car last year. This car runs second to him.
Come on. I'll come on down with you.
I watched that 3 car last year hugging them cars.
Yeah.
Keeping his run going. And then I seen Joe coming. I knew he was going to be okay. And this car finished second to Dale Earnhardt last year. Bless his heart. We missed him dearly here. I learned so much from that fall race here. And if anybody rode with me, he did. And thanks this guy right here, Joe.
Good job, man.
Joe Boy Holmes car.
To congratulate him.
I'm just tickled death for Square D. They've been fighting the long, hard road and everything. And Chevrolet, Goodyear tires. I mean, we were better on old tires. Goodyear tires are off. Unical, anything I'm missing, I'm sorry. I'm new at this car, and I'm going to tell you what. I'm just happy to be here. I got a great teammate and a real good team.
You and Joe look absolutely physically drained. Was it the heat or the concentration, Bobby?
I tell you, I'm just really proud of everybody we raced against today because I think it wore us out mentally just trying to be safe out there. I see more give and take today than I ever have here, and I'm just really proud of the people we raced against. This makes you proud of being Winston Cup.
We had what we needed. We had a safe race, and congratulations to you as the winner.
Thanks.
I challenge anybody that don't think these guys are athletes. They just run 500 miles in 3 hours. Cockpits of those race cars, 130, 140 degrees. I challenge you if you don't think they're an athlete.
And Nemechek, who pushed Hamilton up into the lead, ended up sixth. Tony Stewart, the runner-up. Kurt Busch, first time ever here, is third.
Impressive run by that rookie, I'm telling you.
In fact, 5 rookies finished on the lead lap today.
Dale Jarrett, 18th.
And again, I just want to reiterate, this race was run the way it was run today because of what happened this morning. That black flag will get these guys' attention. You drop below that yellow line, you're coming into pits.
You don't see that much. Jeff Gordon, 28th at Talladega.
No. 1 second off the lead, and he finishes 28th. These cars out of the race at the finish. We'll be back to Talladega. on Fox after this.
The closest shave is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Mach 3. Easy loading, easy rinsing with no clogging. And three blades that shave closer in one easy stroke. Mach 3 from Gillette.
You like it fast? Get to Goodyear, where right now you'll get a $50 fast credit when you buy 4 selected tires on your Goodyear card account. That's $50 coming your way. For complete details from the retailer nearest you, call 1-800-GOODYEAR.
4 identical cars. 4 identical engines. Only one running on New Havoline, our latest triumph in Havoline motor oil technology. And what difference does that make? Not only do you get unsurpassed performance, but tests show that with New Havoline under the hood, you get better gas mileage. Havoline. Add more life to your car.
Buy 12 quarts of Havoline motor oil and get this die-cast collectible for just $5.99 while they last.
You ready, guys? This could be the ride of your life. You gotta get past the myths and the excuses. Erectile difficulty is a common problem. Effective treatment is available. Talk to your doctor. You might be surprised how easily you can get through it.
Dear Torch Committee, I'm the bus driver at Lincoln Elementary. I take the kids to school, and I see Janet out there at the crosswalk every day making sure the kids get across the street safely. She doesn't get to sit or have a heater like me, and still she's out there rain or shine. I nominate crossing guard Janet Regan for the Torch Relay.
Beer is only as good as the ingredients used to brew it. That's why Budweiser uses only the finest all-natural ingredients, hand-selected to deliver a taste, a smoothness, and a drinkability you won't find in any other beer at any price.
This bug's for you.
This is Bill. Bill is installing a new belt on his car. The belt he purchased isn't exactly right, but it seemed like a bargain, and Bill's determined to get it on there. That one might be a little tight, Bill. Here's the deal. At NAPA, we not only carry the right part, we've got the know-how to make sure that's what you leave the store with.
Check this out.
Bob here needs a car.
Whoa. How about a pickup? A black one. With a place for my butt.
AutoTrader.com. Over 1.5 million used cars, make it the biggest, best used car site on the planet.
Need a loan?
Oh, yeah.
AutoTrader.com. Your car is waiting.
Bobby Hamilton continues to celebrate in victory lane, exhausted mentally and perhaps also physically, as he hoists the trophy with Randy Owen, the Grand Marshal of the Talladega 500.
Good for Andy Petrie. His first win as a car owner. He's done a lot for this sport. Good for him.
We'll hear from Andy in a bit, but first, Steve Burns.
Mark, before this day started, you said your goal was to walk out of here one piece, safe race, you got that, in a top five.
I think we're all going to do that, and I think that's just incredible. And I've said to everyone, my quote is the drivers deserve a gold medal, and they really do. And I think that the drivers that held back and laid back made it possible. I don't think we could have done it in a 43-car pack on that.
And it was a career day for rookie Kurt Busch. What was your strategy on the last lap?
It's something I might say for Daytona, but I wanted to brew it up with about two to go, and that 55 and 33 car came together, beat the left sides off their cars like they needed to get to the front, so it spoiled mine, but we showed some patience. We showed them that we can hang out and push the leader around so that we could break away. Just a great day for the Sharpie car.
A great day, and he also earned a lot of respect from his fellow competitors.
Tony Stewart, so close. Take us through that final lap when Bobby Hamilton went by you, and did you see him, and what were you thinking?
Well, when I saw him get the run, I knew he was going to be able to get by with the momentum he had. I was just hoping we didn't go from first back to like 20th in one or two laps. So, you know, to be honest, I was just happy that we were able to hold on there at the end.
Well, for a guy who came into this thing saying he had no plan, this turned out pretty good. Congratulations on the second.
That's why we did so good. We didn't have a plan.
And to crew chief Andy Petrie, one here with Phil Part. He also won with Harry Kent, and he also won with a great one, Dale Earnhardt. Today is his first win in 5 years as a crew chief, and you did it at Talladega. How big is this?
We'll call it car owner this time, but
car owner.
I'll tell you what, it's so big, and I couldn't have done it without all our sponsors. Square D, Oakwood, Chevrolet, all of them have stuck with me, and people like Ken Schrader just came and congratulated me. Without great friends and good people, couldn't have done it. I can't say enough about these Square D guys. Jimmy Ellis finally gets to put one in his win column. I've been getting on him about putting one in that column. He finally did. And Bobby Hamilton and Joe Nemechek, those guys were the best. And the teamwork that they showed today made me the proudest car owner here at Talladega.
How proud are you, your driver, Bobby Hamilton?
Well, I can't say enough about Bobby Hamilton. We knew he was a great race car driver when we got him, but we didn't have any idea how good he really was.
Attaboy, attaboy. Let's go upstairs.
Never over till it's over here again, Darrell. The driver who leads the most laps, Sterling Marlin, who led 51 today, did not win, finished 23rd, but with a very good car.
Yeah, well, I think Larry would agree that most of the time a guy out front all day long, he's a setting duck. The guy coming from back, just like Bobby Hamilton did, that's the guy you got to keep your eye on.
Here are your Winston Cup point standings. Jeff Gordon lost some ground to Dale Jarrett. Johnny Benson gained some and now has sole position of third place. Bobby Hamilton moves up into fourth. Sterling Marlin drops to fifth. A look at the rest of the top 20. Mark Martin breaking up in there. He had a fourth place finish today.
Kevin Harvick, 11th in the points. Still short one race because of not running the Daytona 500.
We'll be back with more from the Talladega Super Speedway after this.
The new crop of vehicles from Dodge includes one really bad apple. Dodge, coming soon to a racetrack near you. Bosch Platinum Plus 4. Four electrodes. Pure platinum. Take your engine to a higher power. Bosch Platinum Plus 4.
Keys.
Nice.
There's only one way in. My way.
Meanwhile, back in the real world, when you're in a jam,
I'm locked out.
Just dial down the center. 1-800-CALL-ATT and save big bucks on every call.
There goes your deposit.
Use 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Why is it that at Howard Johnson you can always count on a data port for fast internet access? Great Super Miles rewards, like free airline tickets. A coffee maker to keep you working away. And a pool to keep everyone smiling. Why? Because at Howard Johnson, it comes right out of the book. The Howard Johnson Book of Quality Standards, which is our way of assuring you a better quality of life on the road. Call 1-800-I-GO-HOJO or visit hojo.com.
Hey, it's time to clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel. Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser. It helps lift dirt and oil from your face to the foam, cleaning while you shave. So clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel.
The Talent 500 presented by Subway, brought to you by Subway, showing the world how great a fresh sandwich can taste. Subway, eat fresh. By the makers of the all-new Dodge Caravan, Dodge, different. And by Valvoline MaxLite, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines.
We've just completed the first caution-free Winston Cup race since Michigan in June of 1999. Let's go down to Matt.
Well, the number for Sterling Marlin now reaches 157 races since your last win at Daytona. What about today? You led the most laps, but you still didn't get the win. What happened, Sterling?
Well, all the guys on the Coors Light Dodge team, they done a real good job, and we just got boxed at the end. They got to do something to fix it. We could run 200, 205 and get these cars separated. The wicker stirred up so much air, and it comes down to 20 or 30 to go. And, you know, pretty much early in the race, give and take. Everybody lets somebody go, and when it comes 20 to go, 30 to go, everybody starts boxing each other in, and me and Dale Jarrett rode around for 10 laps, nose to tail, half throttle. And we couldn't pass on left, couldn't pass on the right, just boxed in. And, man, they got to take a serious look at this and fix it somehow.
How frustrating is it to not be able to move knowing how potent of a race car you have?
It was a lot. I knew we had a good car. I think Dale Jr. was back there with us. Gordon was back there with us, and there's nowhere to go. And side of my car looks like it's been running Martinsville. And it's just miraculous we didn't have the big one, you know, five to go, because, I mean, it was some wild stuff going on. But pleading with them, they got to fix this stuff.
Well, you led the most laps and finished 23rd. To Jeannie.
Well, Bobby Hamilton said there was only one guy here that he would trust at the track, and that is Joe Nemechek, and for good reason. Can you talk about the victory for a friend and teammate?
Well, I'm so happy for Andy Petrie Racing, Square D, Oakwood Homes. Bobby Hamilton, you know, he came on board this year, and he's helped me more than you'd ever know. I mean, we've just been able to communicate really good, and the teams have gelled. Everything's been going good, and the race today, for me, I kept getting shuffled out. You know, we led there for a while. Our car was good. We could get to the front, but when the cars were three wide, my car didn't like to be the first one in line, and I was pushing Bobby, and Dale Jr. kept giving me the bump in the back pretty hard, and it come down to the last lap, gave Bobby a pretty hard hit, knocked the front end on my car, but it's just enough to get him in front of Stewart. And then I knew I'm the first car on the outside, so I'm in bad shape, but Dale Jr. just kept pushing, and Bobby was doing all he could to help. But I'm just glad this Andy Petrie Racing team has got a win. My hat's off to Bobby.
Despite all the pushing, a clean race to Steve Burns.
Thanks, Jeannie, with Johnny Benson, who finished seventh. Johnny, I heard your crew chief, James Ince, said wait till the last lap. What happened?
Well, I guess a couple guys got on the outside or nothing I could do, but Valvoline Eagle One Pontiac was just really good. And I thought I had a shot there with Mark behind me. He ain't going to make a run. It just didn't happen. And but pretty good day. You know, we wanted to stay at the back. Broke a jack early on. Didn't want to be that far back. But and then it started coming up good. And really got to thank everybody on the Valvoline, you know, racing team. And everybody at Hendrick Motorsports, Kevin and Don, Andre doing an excellent job. Of course, James Ince, Gary Putnam, Tim Turner, just everybody. I mean, just good job. And associate sponsor, Colin Carey. I tell you what, we're just can't be any happier. Raise more money for Big Brothers, Big Sisters. Being in top 10, it's just a good day. I mean, we wanted to stay at the back all day until it was time to go, and we did that. I was getting worried every once in a while and getting anxious, and James is, hold on, and then go, and I couldn't believe he finished seventh. I was right behind the third guy in third.
All right, great run, Johnny. He's going to help load the team truck, a team player, Johnny Benson.
Well, Steve, our third top 10 finish of the year for the reigning Winston Cup champion. Now, did the strategy pay off? I mean, you were laughing about this yesterday, to hang back and then move up, but it appears as if it did.
A
blind luck, I think. Okay. That's what it was. But, you know, for a while there, I mean, you know, just when you got back in the back or something and they're three wide, four wide, you know, really wasn't much sense in doing much because you couldn't go anywhere. But, you know, there we made some pit stops there and got mid-pack, and that helped us out. And we got up in the top six, top seven, and stayed there for a long time. And then we got shuffled back there about 20 to go and got back up, you know, to fifth or sixth place there. And it was a good run for us and all these guys, the Interstate Batteries Pontiac. This is the same car we raced to Daytona. We got a whole new body on it and all tore up down there and fixed it up brand new. So did a good job. We didn't even go test it or have any wind tunnel time on it. So congratulations to Bobby Hamilton for winning. That was great. And for us finishing the top 10, it's a good deal.
To Steve Burns.
Thanks, Jeannie. Mike Wallace had a top 10 at Daytona again here at Talladega. Mike,
hey, how about that? Ultra Motorsports Nations ran forward. I mean, it was good. The pit stops were really good today, and the Yates group gave us some good motors. I mean, that was an intensely tough race out there, but, you know, I just got to thank Jim Smith, all the guys, Jim Long, our new crew chief, and all the guys on pit road did a wonderful job. You know, we don't get many times this year to thank our sponsor, Nations Rent, so if anybody needs a bulldozer tomorrow, you know where to go get one, but that was a mentally tough race. I mean, we were on the outside. There was about 20 to go and needed some help. You know, we were sixth and just kind of going and thought we were going to be okay, but hey, a great day until Dr. Dick. I told him we'd run nonstop today. He didn't believe me. All right, congratulations, Mike.
Well, Dick Bergeron was right at the top of the show that everyone would walk away, hop on a plane, and go in good health to California, and we will next Friday. Go California dreaming with Winston Cup qualifying on FX. You'll see it at 8 p.m. Friday night Eastern time. Then on Saturday, final practice on FX at 2:30 Eastern. The NASCAR Busch Series on Fox at 3:30. And then on Sunday, NASCAR This Morning, the Napa 500 at 2 p.m. here on Fox, and then NASCAR Victory Lane. 28 cars finish 500 miles within 1 second of each other, a caution-free race. What a great day.
I'm proud of my drivers. This is the most disciplined race I've seen at Talladega, maybe anywhere in my 30 years.
Yeah, just to have a safe day. Safe day on pit road. No pit road incidents. Just before we leave here with a great feeling.
That we do, and we go down trackside for final thoughts to Chris Myers.
A record of 27 different leaders. That's a Winston Cup racing record, Jeff Hammond. And if fans tuned in to see the big one, they saw the big safe one. It isn't easy being green. How did they pull it off, the drivers today?
You folks at home saw what intimidation can be, because I think NASCAR got in everybody's head. But at the same time, I believe what happened at Daytona was riding around in everybody's mind, and they realized that they had to take care of themselves, and they did that today.
How about Bobby Hamilton? Here's a guy who ran a car in the shooting of the movie Days of Thunder, which starred Tom Cruise. He's a former Rookie of the Year, but a guy who had been accused, and maybe unfairly so, Jeff, of not living up to the hype.
I've worked with Bobby Hamilton. There's not a finer guy in that garage area. He stayed at my house before. He's driven my race cars. And if I had to pick a man today to go start a race team with, he would be my choice, because he knows his race cars. He works really good with people. You put him in the right situation as far as chemistry is concerned, as Andy Petrie has said, he's getting the job done. These guys are for real. They're up there in the points. They're winning races. They're getting the job done.
Fourth career win for Bobby Hamilton. For Jeff Hammond, I'm Chris Myers. Thanks for being with us. From the emotional start at Daytona to the drama now, this season has been something Dale Earnhardt would have been proud of.
Somewhere up there, up in Dale's
mind. You got it, Mikey. You got it, man. You got it. Come on, man. You got it. You got it. You got it. You got it.
My daddy would be so happy.
Got a big old lump in my throat.
What could be more fitting? What could be more special?
baseball's postseason. The 72nd All-Star Game. And beginning June 2nd, the Saturday Baseball Game of the Week. You're watching Fox Sports.